With family or friends, you know no game day is complete without your favorite snack. So enjoy Golden Flake or any of our other delicious snacks from the Utz family of brands and sit back for the rest of the game. Golden Flake and Auburn football, a winning team. Simple Southern goodness, Golden Flake. Celebrating 66 years as the official salty snack of the Auburn Tigers.
As a coach, you don't just put any player on the line. You've got to make the right choice and recruit the right people, train them, give them experience, and coach them up so they're ready when you call. I'm Kenny Mullins for the International Brotherhood of Electrical Workers, Local 613. And that's how we feel about our electricians. Our electricians are recruited, educated, and trained on the job to become the top 1% of electricians anywhere. So we're ready when you call. Make the right choice. Hire IBEW electricians. Learn more at IBEW613.org.
There's certain core values that I think we have to all buy into totally, and the first one is faith. You have to believe in something bigger than yourself to be a great football team.
Dr. Baker, say a silent prayer for Al Delgrecco.
Attitude. Attitude is how we talk to ourselves.
To the 15, 10, go crazy, Cadillac! Go crazy!
Mental toughness. We must have it. It's the secret sauce.
Hicks steps up, he throws to Williams. He's got it! Touchdown, Auburn!
Integrity is not always getting it right, or none of us would have it. It's really when you don't get it right, what do you do?
Howard wants to throw. Howard fires. Pass is tipped around. It's intercepted at the 40, the 35, the 30, the 20, the 10. He's gone! Robinson, touchdown!
Love. The next core value is the ability to handle inconveniences that come with relationships.
Campbell in the end zone.
And the last is why, which is you. We need the fans. We need the Auburn family.
The atmosphere, the crowd, the roar.
That's what's special about this place. What's special about the Auburn family.
Donovan's going to go very long. Four Beasley. Nobody's going to go. Jackson. Down Auburn.
Up the middle, up and over. And Abraham Nation. He is good.
The kick is good. Auburn wins.
Out of the gun. Play action. They throw. Wide open. Touchdown.
To the 15, to the 10, he's gone!
Auburn has reached the midway mark of the season, still in search of his first SEC win. Mississippi State comes to the Plains in a must-win for both teams' bids for a postseason bowl. Good afternoon, and War Eagle from Jordan-Hare Stadium. With Jason Campbell, Ronnie Brown, Paul Allen, Brad Law, Gene Dulaney, Patrick Tisdale, and Ben Harling. I'm Andy Burcham. In the last three games, Auburn has faced the top three offenses in the league. The Tigers fell just a touchdown short against number one Georgia and number 13 Ole Miss here at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Last season, that Mississippi State game was the first with Cadillac Williams as interim head coach, and the Tigers fell in overtime in Starkville. There is reason for optimism. Last week, Jarquez Hunter returned to form with 91 yards and a pair of touchdowns. And Damari Alston has returned to practice this week and is available today. State comes to the Plains after a 7-3 win at Arkansas. Will Rogers, the most prolific passer in the SEC, didn't play, snapping a string of 38 straight starts. It looks like Vanderbilt transfer Mike Wright will get his second straight start for the Bulldogs today. State looks for its third straight win over Auburn. It's time to snap that streak and jumpstart the rest of this season. The Outdoor Alabama Countdown to Kickoff continues in a moment.
Hey y'all, this is Ronte, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the pimento cheese. I was like, go cheese, go pimento, go honey, go get it.
Hi, this is Chantrese, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the mild spiciness of the pickled jalapenos. No, it's the crispy chicken. Actually, I can't decide. It's the entire sandwich.
Order the honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Available for a limited time. Real Chick-fil-A guests paid for their testimonials.
How are you the ultimate Auburn fan?
Because I got this air horn installed in my throat.
Pretty sick, right?
Yes.
You look really sick. What doctor would even do this?
Doctor? I did this myself. I mean, I can't swallow whole food, but still.
Wait, what?
Just gotta plow through it. Hey, can I get a cup?
couple of soups up there.
What about some chamomile tea?
Don't be that guy. Get a fan card. The smart way to be the ultimate Tigers fan. Just go to auburncards.com.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical.
You always say Vibrantly Tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
It's game day. What do you take to the tailgate? A flat screen TV? Take it to the tailgate. Your wife's favorite blender? The DJ sound system? With a Ford F-150 truck, you can take it all. With available Pro Power onboard that acts like a mobile generator, you can use F-150 to take your tailgate to the next level. Visit your local Ford dealer today. The Auburn Tigers and Ford F-150. Greatness starts here. See owner's manual for important operating instructions.
You're listening to Auburn Football. Now back to more of the Outdoor Alabama Countdown to Kickoff. Visit OutdoorAlabama.com to find your next adventure. Go hunt. Go fish. Get outdoors.
Welcome back to Jordan-Hare Stadium. It's a sea of orange. All Auburn, all orange here today as Auburn entertains Mississippi State. Along with Jason Campbell, I'm Andy Burcham, our entire Auburn Sports Network crew. Glad to have you with us today on the Auburn Sports Network. For more than 100 years, Eagles have been associated with the Auburn football program. Today, Independence continued that tradition that is uniquely Auburn by circling the stadium and landing near midfield. Her flight represents the combined efforts of the Auburn College of Veterinary Medicine, Auburn University Raptor Center, and the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service in promoting the conservation of all birds of prey. Auburn drum majors are out. The mace about to be thrown into the turf here at Jordan-Hare Stadium. The Auburn University Marching Band will then be parading onto the field for the pregame festivities today. Great things are possible when you have the power, performance, and smart features of a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Greatness starts at your local Ford dealer. Jason Campbell, what are your Ford keys to today's game?
Yeah, and today is a big game for both of these teams, but let's go with Auburn first. Auburn offense must get into a rhythm early. Tempo offense is, I think, what we got to see today out of our offense to be more efficient. Auburn offense needs to also be better on third downs today. Our defense have been playing great, one of the number one red zone defenses in the country and in the SEC, but we got to eliminate bad plays on third downs and give an opponent an opportunity to get first downs. And last for me is continue to create turnovers like this Auburn defense has done. They lead the SEC in red zone defense and third in turnover margin. I'd like to see Jalen Simpson continue his streak of creating turnovers the way he has this year.
Yeah, the Auburn team is right now plus three in a turnover margin. Mississippi State tied for fifth in the league at plus two. You have talked about those two linebackers in the middle of the defense. Nathaniel Watson out of Maplesville, Alabama, with 71 tackles, co-SEC Defensive Player of the Week, averaging 10.1 tackles. He had 14 tackles, two for loss, two sacks last week at Arkansas. And then on the other side, Jet Johnson from Tupelo, Mississippi, 77 tackles. He led the league in tackles a year ago with 115. Safe to say they are around the ball all the time.
Yeah, it's safe to say, Andy, those guys have a nose for the football. They know exactly where the ball is going to be at. You know, anytime you have two really good linebackers like State has, you know, they're not afraid to get physical. They're not afraid of you running the football because they feel like that works in their advantage. They feel like they have the rushing defense to be able to stop opponents from rushing the ball as much as we like. But I do think, as well as those linebackers are, I do think we can have an opportunity with this secondary, though. I think if our receivers can get open and we can find some ways to utilize play action behind our run game, I think we'll have an opportunity today to hit some of those guys on the intermediate routes.
On the other side of the ball, we do believe it will be Mike Wright to start at quarterback today for State. Senior transfer from Vanderbilt, 16 of 23 on the year for 146 yards. Last week, 8 of 12, 85 yards, a touchdown and an interception, but he gives you an added dimension as a very good runner.
Yeah, Mike Wright, he's not the passer that Will Rogers is. Of course, Will Rogers was with Mike Leach for those couple of years, and it was very air raided, one of the best in the country. But you think about this offense that State likes to run now and running the football in short passing game. They like to control the clock, Andy, a lot of it because of the defense that they feel like they have. But you talk about Mike Wright, he's an experienced guy. It's not like he's coming in here with no experience. He played at Vanderbilt. He transferred to State. He might actually fit this offense a little bit better just because of the fact that Will is more of a passer. He's more of a run or the quarterback. So our defense has got to pay attention to him today backside. You can't overflow because of the threat of him keeping the ball and coming out on some of the backside of those RPOs.
Wright with 2,313 yards and 23 touchdowns through the air. He's also thrown 12 interceptions in his career, but he's also run for over 1,100 yards and 10 more rushing touchdowns as well. He is a true dual-threat quarterback that Auburn gets today.
Yeah, most definitely he's a dual-threat quarterback, and I just feel like for us, you know, we've got to create an opportunity where we don't let them hit explosive plays. Last week he hit a big run against Arkansas, but it got called back because of legal blind block. So we have to be alert at all times of him keeping the ball, especially we're not sure if their running back is going to go today or not in Mark. So you have to understand that if he's not going, then they have a younger group of running backs behind him. So that means they're probably going to rely a little bit more on Mike Wright in the run game as well as in the pass game. So we got to be alert for boots and neck is Andy. Our linebackers have got to pay attention to the tight ends in this game because they don't want to let those guys get behind you.
It is Military Appreciation Day. God Bless America being played and sung right now at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Stay tuned. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
War Eagle, it's a great day for Auburn Tigers to get vaccinated. Many children and adults that delayed vaccinations during the pandemic are still behind schedule. It's crucial that we take steps to get everyone back on track with their routine immunizations. Children and teens can still catch up on their vaccinations even if they start late. Make sure you and your family are all up to date on all recommended vaccines, including COVID-19 and flu. Let's all do our part to get back on track. Don't wait. Vaccinate. For more information, visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham.
The first player that I talked to at Auburn University was this linebacker named Quentin Riggins.
We will not be staying for the full game. Quentin has to be at work at 5 o'clock, and we're leaving at halftime. And Coach sat back. He nodded and said, okay. And he said, well, I hope you enjoy the game and so forth. Now, understand, I'm dying. I'm under the table here. I'm getting a chance to come. I get to meet Bo Jackson. But little did I know how important that was in my growth, my opportunity, and what propelled me to be on Auburn's radar even more so.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
Adventure is waiting for you at Alabama State Parks. So, pack your bags. With so much to explore, there's something for everybody. Whether you're hiking the foothills of the Appalachians or wading into the warm waters of the Gulf, finding a vacation that you and your family will love comes naturally at any one of our Alabama State Parks. To learn more, call 800-ALAPARK or visit alapark.com. This message brought to you by your Alabama State Parks.
This is tight end Luke Deal, and these are the Yellowwood starting lineups for the Tigers.
Defensive line.
Jason Jones, Calera, Alabama, Calera High School.
Marcus Harris, Montgomery, Alabama, Paul Crossing High School.
Kildrick Falk, Highland Home School, Highland Home.
Linebackers.
Elijah McAllister, Asbury Park, New Jersey, Rumson Fairhaven Regional High School.
Eugene Asante, Alexandria, Virginia, Westfield High School.
Larry Nixon, Richland Hills, Richland High School.
Secondary.
DJ James, Mobile, Alabama, Spanish Fort High School.
Nehemiah Preach, Jackson, Alabama, Jackson High School.
Zion Puckett, Griffin, Georgia, Sparta High School.
Jalen Simpson, Brunswick, Georgia, Frederica Academy.
Donovan Coffey, New Orleans, Louisiana, Archbishop Roman High School.
Offensive line.
Dylan Wade, Houston, Texas, Sipos.
Gunnar Britton, Conway, South Carolina, Conway High School.
Connor Liu, Kennesaw, Georgia, Kennesaw Mountain High School.
Cam Stutz, Killen, Alabama, Brooks High School.
Isaiah Miller, Memphis, Tennessee, Whitdale High School.
Receivers.
Rivaldo Ferrer, Lauderdale, Florida, Boyd Anderson High School.
Caleb Burton, Houston, Texas, Lake Travis High School.
Jay Fair, Dallas, Texas, Rockwall Heath High School.
Jair Shorter, Killeen, Texas, Ellison High School.
Running back.
Jacquez Hunter, Philadelphia, Mississippi, Neshoba Central High School.
Quarterback.
Peyton Thorne, Naperville, Illinois, Naperville Central High School.
Special teams.
Reed Hughes, Conway, Arkansas, Conway High School.
Oscar Chapman, Adelaide, South Australia, Prince Alfred College.
Alex McPherson, Fort Payne, Alabama, Fort Payne High School.
The starting lineups have been brought to you by Great Southern Wood, makers of Yellowwood pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
You've been listening to the Outdoor Alabama Countdown to Kickoff on the Auburn Sports Network. Now, it's game time. Exclusive play-by-play coverage of Auburn football is brought to you by Ford. Visit your local Ford dealer, proud sponsor of the Auburn Tigers. The Alabama Department of Public Health. Don't wait. Vaccinate. Protect yourself and others by staying current on all recommended vaccines. Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM. By Cook's Pest Control and the Centricon System, the unbeatable combination for termite protection. Chick-fil-A. Download the Chick-fil-A app and score big before the game begins. And by Alabama Power, proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers. Alabama Power, power for a better Alabama. Let's go back to Jordan-Hare Stadium with Ronnie Brown on the sidelines. And alongside Jason Campbell, here's the voice of the Auburn Tigers, Andy Burcham.
We welcome you back to Jordan-Hare Stadium in a wash of orange on this day as the Auburn Tigers get set to face the Mississippi State Bulldogs. We await Auburn's entrance to Pat Dye Field in front of a jam-packed over 88,000 on hand for today's game. Auburn's captains are out at midfield. They await the toss of the coin. The Tigers in their blue jerseys, the white numerals, white trousers, and the classic AUs on the helmets as on this military appreciation day. Four helicopters flew overhead during the national anthem here this afternoon as the Auburn Tigers start to make their way out of the locker room on the south side of Jordan-Hare Stadium and about to make their entrance onto Pat Dye Field. We understand Mike Wright will get the start for Mississippi State today, the transfer from Vanderbilt, the quarterback. Numerous reports as well that Jaquavius Marks, the team's leading rusher out of Atlanta with 97 carries and 500 yards, will not play today as well. So Jeffrey Pittman expected to get the start as the Auburn Tigers come on to the playing surface here at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Game day weather forecast presented by Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Celebrate responsibly. 78 degrees, partly cloudy skies. A little bit of a wind out of the northeast today at Jordan-Hare Stadium. No mention of rain in the forecast for some time forward here in Lee County. Jason, this is a big ball game for both of these teams, and for Auburn, well, you just want to see some consistency from an offensive standpoint.
Yeah, definitely, Andy, being the Halloween is coming up in a couple of days. Today for this offense, it's going to have to be trick or treat. And what I mean by that is you're going to treat us with a good effort today and come out and be explosive, or you're going to get tricked and look like some of the offenses that we looked like the last couple of weeks. And I think today Coach Freeze talked about trying to find just one guy to rally right behind as a quarterback. So I think today we'll see more of a one quarterback system. I still think you'll see both guys at some point, but we've got to figure out how to get going offensively and how to be explosive in our offense as well.
Auburn's team captains to midfield. The toss of the coin is presented by Key of Auburn, where you're always number one. Daniel Gautreau is today's referee.
Call is tails. It is tails.
Like defer.
You like to defer. Which way would you like to kick? All right, it's short side.
All right, guys. 80 degrees on October the 28th in Auburn, Alabama. Mississippi State's captain has elected to defer the second half. Of course, actually, after winning the toss. They're going to kick off. Auburn's offense is up first. Guys in the booth, what is the key for this Auburn offense? And whoever's the starting quarterback comes out this first drive, how do they get something established?
Yeah, Ronnie, you talk about coming out and starting fast. You know, Coach Freeze mentioned this week that he wanted to get something going from a tempo standpoint. I think now that we've faced the last four offenses, it's been top four in the SEC. Now we're in the bottom half of the offenses that we're facing down the stretch here that's last in the SEC. I think it gives us an opportunity to go tempo because our defense don't have to worry about staying on the field or going as fast when they're on the field. So I do think today from an offensive standpoint, our quarterbacks have got to play well. We've got to be better on third downs, and we've got to be more efficient in the red zone. So we got to get touchdowns today and put some pressure on this Mississippi State offense with a backup quarterback.
It's an Auburn offense that is fourth in the league, averaging 186 yards rushing. It's fifth in the league with 15 rushing touchdowns, and six different Tigers have scored a rushing touchdown this year. And Auburn gets Damari Alston back in that backfield today as well, behind or in addition to Brian Battee and Jeremiah Cobb and, of course, Jarquez Hunter.
Yeah, getting Damari Alston back, Andy, is huge. You know, he's another guy. He's a physical runner. He's that great 1-2 punch to Jarquez. And like I said, he runs hard between the tackles. And I think his experience, not just in the run game, but in pass game, picking up blitzes and certain exotic looks that State will give us a little bit today, especially against that two-headed monster linebacker group that they have. So we got to come prepared for everything today. Offensively, this is a great start for us. We're going to receive the ball here first and see what our offense can go out there and get some tempo going and get this crowd behind us.
Nick Barmira is the kickoff specialist for Mississippi State, with Sean Jackson and Brian Battee to return for Auburn. But they were never a factor a week ago. All the kickoffs were out of the back of the end zone. You'd love to see Brian Battee get his hands on a ball early in that kickoff or the kickoff return role here afternoon.
Yeah, both kickers last week, Andy, they put on a show. They was kicking the ball out the end zone. They was punting the ball extremely deep. Brian Battee is one of those guys that we said before, it's only a matter of time before he breaks one. And this guy's electric with the ball in his hands.
Has over 2,100 kickoff return yards in his career. And Barmira puts a right foot into it. Low line drive kick. It to the right of Battee. It lands at the goal line and out of the back of the end zone. And so Auburn will have first down and 10 at its own 25. And it's Peyton Thorne who will bring the offense out. Transfer from Michigan State is 80 of 130 this season, 61.5%. 845 yards, 5 touchdowns, 5 interceptions for the Auburn Tigers. And he brings Auburn to the line of scrimmage with Jarquez Hunter flanking him to the left. Double wide receivers to the wide side of the field for Auburn to the right. That's Jay Fair and Malcolm Johnson Jr. In the slot to the left, Camden Brown. Hand off, Jarquez Hunter right up the middle. Jarquez Hunter for 10 yards and 12 yards and a first down for Auburn before Marcus Branks brings him down.
Exactly what you want to see, Andy, on the first play of the game. Get some positive yard. We have negative plays over the last couple of weeks. Great start for Auburn.
11 yards on first down for Jarquez Hunter. Auburn scrimmages from the right hash. Brings Jay Fair in motion. Play action, nope. It's a handoff to Jarquez off the right side, bounces to the outside, gets near the 40-yard line before he's driven back. We'll give him 4 yards. So he has gone for 11 yards and 4 yards on his first two carries. Dontari Russell with the stop for Mississippi State.
Yeah, Dontari Russell has a brother on the team as well, Demonte Russell. Two brothers that's playing for the same school. Pretty unique.
Second and 6 for Auburn. Nose of the football at the 40. Right hash mark for the Tigers. Single wide receivers right and left. Tight end Fairweather in motion to the Mississippi State boundary. Thorne to throw to the sideline. Complete to the 45. It is complete up the left sideline. Caleb Burton Jr. He's into Mississippi State territory. Down to the 44-yard line and a first down for Auburn.
Yeah, we talked about it pregame. The way to get your quarterbacks involved in the game is to give some quick plays, hitches, slants, right there, a gain of 16 to Caleb Burton.
Just the fourth catch of the year for Burton. Auburn right back to the line of scrimmage, an empty set. Thorne looks, he throws it up the sideline, down the sideline, and overthrows Malcolm Johnson Jr.
Yeah, Malcolm right there got a little pressure off the edge right there by Dontari Russell. Right there creating pressure. Have to let that ball go a little bit earlier than he wanted to on Malcolm Johnson trying to run a seam ball.
Johnson with single coverage from Marcus Banks. The ball was just overthrown. Second and 10 for Auburn at the Mississippi State 45-yard line. A bunch set for the Tigers. Three receivers line up on the right side of the offensive line from the left hash. Hand off to the tailback. bounces to the outside, now ahead near the 40. Good second effort inside the 40 to the 38-yard line by Jarquez Hunter. 7 yards for Hunter, and a lot of that on second effort by the Philadelphia, Mississippi native.
Yeah, great effort by Jarquez right there, growing up not too far from Mississippi State, which is located in Starkville from Philadelphia, Mississippi. This is a big game for him. I'm pretty sure he wants to put on a show in front of his home crowd and school that he kind of probably grew up watching a little bit.
Auburn to 33% on third down. State holding opponents to 37%. This is third and four for Auburn. Fairweather in motion. Handoff goes Jarquez. Excuse me. A flag comes down. And a false start for Auburn.
Number 52. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
Left tackle Dylan Wade. Boy, moving early. Boy, last week against Ole Miss, those penalties just killed the Tigers. That cannot continue to happen here today. So instead of third and four, it's third and nine now for Auburn.
You're exactly right, Andy. Last week, those penalties in crucial downs and plays on the field just hurt us.
Line to get is the State 35. There was movement this time, maybe a free play, as Thorne loads it up, sends it down to the sideline, and it's incomplete, intended for Shane Hooks.
Yeah, I think we're going to get offsides on the defense here.
The Auburn's going to get the 5 yards back.
Offsides. Defense, number 22, was in the neutral zone at the snap. 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
That's the nose guard, Nathan Pickering, 6'4", 305, a senior from Mount Olive, Mississippi, who had a career-high 8 tackles earlier this season at South Carolina. So, third and four, here we go again. Ball on the left hash. State with 4 on the line of scrimmage as Thorne looks to the Auburn sideline. Play clock at 12. Jarquez Hunter flanks him to the left. There's the snap to Thorne. Short drop, looks, throws, pass complete. Jay Fair, and he's going to be close. He's got the first down at the 34-yard line for the Tigers.
Yeah, great route right there by Jay Fair, running inside slant right there. Thorne beating the blitz with this throw. Great job, great accuracy right there, allowing Jay Fair to get the first down after the catch.
Like the tempo early on, Tigers right back to the line of scrimmage. First and 10 from the State 34-yard line. Thorne with the ball in the middle of the field brings Fair in motion. Play action. Now flips the ball to Thorne with some blockers ahead to the 30. Picks his way forward. He gets to the 27-yard line before he's brought down. Good downfield blocking by Camden Brown, the sophomore from Monroe, Louisiana.
Yeah, Camden Brown in the starting lineup today. Like to see a little bit more action from him. He's a star. He's got great talent.
Second and 3 for the Tigers. Back to the line of scrimmage. Play action. Thorne looks. And he has Hollywood Hooks. He dives to the end zone. Touchdown, Auburn! Touchdown, Auburn!
Great job by Thorne right there. Throwing that ball up to Hollywood Hooks, the transfer from Jackson State, Mississippi. Getting the opportunity right there to go up and high point that ball for a gain of 27 for a touchdown. Good job. This is exactly what we want to see from our receivers that came in from the transfer portal. Right there, great start by this Auburn offense. Showing tempo, getting into the end zone. This will get the crowd behind us and get some mojo going for this football team.
Second touchdown of the year for Hooks. That's 14 in his career. And Alex McPherson is out for the extra point. The holder is Chapman. Snap down, kick on the way by McPherson. And the kick is good. And just what the doctor ordered for Auburn. Opening drive, 75 yards and a score. 11:38 to go in the first quarter. Auburn 7, Mississippi State nothing. Auburn football continues in a moment.
People take their chili seriously. At Whataburger, we also put chili on a pedestal. A pedestal made of 100% fresh beef. The Whataburger Chili Cheeseburger, made to order with our own chili on 2 all-beef patties, melty cheese, onions, mustard, and crunchy corn chips. This is Chili Elevated to burger height. The Chili Cheeseburger is back for a limited time. Whataburger, just like you like it.
If SEC football runs deep in your veins, then SiriusXM SEC Radio is what you need to listen to. We're talking conference and team previews, plus hear live games, news, and analysis from experts like Chris Doering, Aaron Murray, and Max Stark. Go in-depth with your favorite team with coaches' shows, championship specials, and more. Get inside SEC football like nowhere else. Feed your fandom on the SiriusXM app. Stay up to date anywhere you go. Just download the app and start streaming.
Kaneka Sausage is a fan favorite for tailgating, always great on the grill, and it's the official sausage dog and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, their patented blend of seasonings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true southern flavor. Be sure to visit the Kaneka gift shop in Evergreen, Alabama, right off I-65 at exit 96. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka sausage dog while watching the Tigers and make Kaneka part of your game day. Kaneka sausage, since 1947, a real winner.
Yellowwood knows that a five-star backyard is the place to make lasting memories. Like roasting marshmallows on a cool fall night. That's it. Turn it nice and slow. Get it toasted all... Oh, no, it's on fire. Oh, you want it on fire. Okay, that's a choice, I guess. Crunchy. For five-star backyards and the most memorable experiences, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
.38 to go in the first quarter. Auburn takes the opening drive on the Sun-South John Deere Drive Summary. 75 yards in eight plays. 3 minutes and 22 seconds. Nice pass from Peyton Thorne to Shane Hollywood Hooks for 27 yards for the touchdown. Thorne, 4 of 5 for 53 yards in the score. Sun-South John Deere, preferred tractor of the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com. Whatever you want to call it, exactly what Auburn needed to open this ball game offensively.
Yes, Andy, that was exactly what Auburn needed. We talked about going tempo. We went with a tempo offense. I think we operate better that way. We actually got our run game started off really good. And then what we do with our quarterback, we get him into a rhythm. We start off with a quick out. We start off with a quick slant. Those high percentage throws that can kind of get a quarterback's rhythm and confidence going.
That is Auburn's first quarter touchdown pass this season. Tulu Griffin, boy, and he is dangerous, is the lone man deep for Mississippi State along with Xavier Thomas. And Alex McPherson will kick this one away towards the north end zone. He kicks it deep, and Tulu will just watch it go about 2 yards deep into the end zone. And here comes Mississippi State with Mike Wright at quarterback. Good size, 6'4", 195, senior out of Fayetteville, Georgia, transfer from Vanderbilt. This season, he's 16 of 23 for 146 yards, a pair of touchdowns, and an interception.
And you talk about Tulu Griffin, the only receiver to have 200 yards and a half and 250 yards receiving in a game. But this offensive line for Mississippi State all have over 20 starts in their career.
Jeffrey Pittman, the starting tailback, a junior from Taylorsville, Mississippi.
Yeah, hometown kid there.
First and 10, left hash mark from the 25. In the pistol, Mississippi State. Bring a man in motion. Play action for Wright. Looks up the seam. He throws. Man is open, and it is caught by Xavier Thomas for a first down for State.
Yeah, we got caught in man coverage right there. DJ James covering. Kind of got lost right there a little bit with running that deep over route by Mississippi State right there. Just a great catch, great play action pass right there to come out trying to catch Auburn's defense off guard.
First down for State, 33 yards. That's the longest pass completion of the season for Wright to the Auburn 43. On the left hash mark. Handoff. Nope, it is Wright again. Throws it and overthrows the intended receiver. Number 3, Justin Robinson, a redshirt junior from McDonough, Georgia. He was working on Nehemiah Pritchett. Second and 10 for State at the Auburn 43 left hash mark.
Yeah, Justin Rogers, big 6'4", 220-pound receiver going against Nehemiah Pritchett right there. You see right now early on, Andy, that State wants to come out and take their chances early with Will Rogers out and their start and their stud running back and Joquavius Marks.
Pittman flanks right to his right. Out of the shotgun, second and 10. Man comes in motion, handoff on the jet sweep inside the Auburn 40, 35-30, and run out of bounds at the 28-yard line. Number 5, Tulu Griffin, senior from Philadelphia, Mississippi, the same hometown as Auburn's Jarquez Hunter, taken out of bounds by Jalen Simpson.
Yeah, Tulu, a guy that they want to get involved in the offense in the passing game and in the run game. Right there, he ran a sweep for about 17 yards, but also took out somebody on the Auburn sidelines.
Zion Puckett comes out of the game for Auburn, talented safety for the Tigers. As State scrimmages first and 10 from the Auburn 26. Wright rolls to his left, will run it. Wright taken down at the 25-yard line. He falls forward to the 23. Keontae Scott came up to make the stop for the Tigers.
Yeah, design sweep run right there by the quarterback right. Mississippi State likes to get him involved a lot in the run game. Auburn's defense have got to be ready for the RPO game from him as well. Sometimes they will fake a sweep and try to throw a quick pass right behind it.
Pittman checks out of the game. I think it's Tulu Griffin that's going to line up in the backfield now for State. So Griffin is the one that flanks the quarterback, Mike Wright. On second and seven from the Auburn 23. Wright pitches the ball to Tulu Griffin, tries to get to the left boundary, and bumped out of bounds by Keontae Scott.
Yeah, big hit by Keontae right there, coming from that nickel star position we call on our defense right there. Keontae coming back last week after missing a couple of games with an injury. We definitely need his presence. He's big in the pass game, but he's also big in our blitz and run package because he's not afraid of contact.
He tried to go to the short side of the field and was held to a one-yard gain on the stop by Keontae. Here is third and seven for State. State 33% on third down, Auburn holding opponents to 36%. Wright with Pittman flanking him. Wright drops the throw, sets and he throws. The pass is complete to Thomas, and Thomas is taken down near the first down marker. Looks like he's gonna be about a half yard shy as he was taken down by Keontae Scott.
Yeah, great tackle right there by Keontae. They run those mesh routes, Andy, what we call drives and crossing routes. Right there, Keontae trailing just a little bit. Great job by Wright of getting the ball to the receiver, but even a better tackle by Keontae holding him short, forcing a fourth and short right here for this defense of Auburn right here. Got to get gritty.
The jumbo package is in right now for Mississippi State. And Rogers checks in at the middle of that Auburn at defensive front. Fourth and less than a yard for Mississippi State. Pittman flanks Wright. Wright's gonna run it. Wright has the first down, second effort, as he was able to get, I'll tell you what, this may be a little bit short. Let's hold the phones. Does he have it? He does. The chains move, first down for State. Yeah. Marcus Harris made the stop.
Yeah, design run right there for Wright. They try to run a quarterback power, what they call that. You get a lead block with the tight end coming over. He also got the big left guard right there trying to help lead the runway right there for Michael Wright for a first down.
Auburn took its initial drive 75 yards for a touchdown. Stale on its first drive. It's first and 10 for State in the Auburn red zone at the 15. Ball inside the right hash. Wright from the pistol with Pittman behind him. Hands the ball to Pittman. Good pressure, good up front. Pittman taken down by Keontae Scott at the 10-yard line.
Man, Keontae Scott coming up today, laying a hammer in the run game right there. Big hit on Pittman right there. Like I said, a young kid from Taylorsville, Mississippi, where I'm from. Transferred over from, I think it was Hines Community College. But Keontae is going to be a presence in this ball game.
6-yard gain. Second and four for State at the Auburn 9. Trips to the Auburn boundary for Mississippi State. Right from the gun. He's going to run it around left end. Now cuts up field, and he's taken down at the 10.5-yard line. Eugene Asante with the stop out of Alexandria, Virginia.
Yeah, big stop by Eugene Asante right there because that was a well-designed play right there. They caught Auburn defense going one way. They came out the backside. They had pullers and guards. If Eugene doesn't make that tackle, that might be a walk-in touchdown for Mike Wright. Big tackle for Eugene. Huge third down right here.
Two wide receivers in the slot to the right for State, Antonio Harmon and Xavier Thomas, two on the left as well. Third and five, Wright with time, throws to the end zone and overthrows his man, intended for Justin Robinson. Keontae Scott was there for the Tigers. Yeah, but Keontae Scott was all over the place on that drive.
Yeah, Keontae Scott right there, definitely showing his presence in this game right there, guarding the big receiver, Justin Robinson. Like I say, 6'4", 220, Keontae, not afraid of contact, not afraid of size. Great job by the Auburn defense right there to hold State to a field goal after what looked to be a promising drive.
The left-footed Kyle Ferry is out for this field goal of 29 yards. Let's see if Jalen Simpson can get close. He did. Ferry's field goal is on the way, and it is good. The clock stopped with 6:20 to go in the first quarter play. Auburn keeps State out of the end zone. Auburn leads it by a score of 7-3. Great things are possible when you have the power, performance, and smart features of Ford F-150. It's the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Greatness starts at your local Ford dealer. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham.
Quint Ricketts, Coach Hall, would always count down. 2 minutes. Then he always had this, like, voice, everything. 2 minutes. He had this whistle with a string. He'd just wrap it up and walk around. And he would find different things to poke the bear, to try to get you going. And this one, I never forget this. You're supposed to be the best. Don't disappoint him. And we're just ripping the doors off and we're running out there. What I realized is my feet were numb.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
We always picture the SEC student athlete for their speed, their vertical, their agility, but it's time we picture them for more. For their campus voice, their community outreach, and for the simple fact that 20 years later, they're still someone's pride and joy. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Mississippi State went 11 plays, 65 yards, 5 minutes and 18 seconds, settling for the 29-yard field goal from Ferry. On that drive, Keontae Scott, 4 tackles of the 10 plays on that drive.
Yeah, Keontae Scott, like I said, this guy's energetic, Andy. I wish we had a whole bunch of guys with his type of mindset and attitude. Like, he's always trying to find an edge or a way to go out there and play with his heart on his sleeves.
Batee is deep. Sean Jackson about 3 yards outside the end zone, awaiting this kickoff by Nick Barmira. Up the middle of the field, Batee, 5 yards into the end zone, drops it in the end zone, and he will take a knee. We'll send it downstairs. A Cook's Pest Control sideline report. Here's Ronnie Brown.
All right, Andy, what I want to see from this Auburn offense is building on what they just did on the offensive side. Peyton Thorne looked like he was in total command of the offense. They looked good. It was a fluid drive. They ran the ball. They were able to get some. Shane Hooks finished the drive off with a long physical touchdown as a receiver, caught it, dragged the defensive back into the end zone. And so that's what you want to see them build on.
Batee stays in the game at tailback for the Tigers. First and 10 from the left hash mark from the 25. Thorne to the sideline, complete at the 30-yard line, and a gain of about 5 on the play by Camden Brown.
Yeah, I like the play call right there. Get a quick drive started right there with a hitch to Camden Brown. Camden Brown, big 6'3", 6'4", receiver. Get him involved in the game. Right now, Jarquez coming in for Batee.
Yep. That will delay the start of this play for the Tigers. So Hunter checks back into the backfield for Auburn. From the left hash, he flanks Peyton Thorne to the quarterback's right. Second down and 4 for Auburn. Fair in motion. Thorne looks for the quarterback draw. He's got it. Peyton Thorne near the 40-yard line. They'll mark him down at the 39, and that's an Auburn first down. Deontay Anderson with the stop, a sophomore from Miami, making his 17th tackle of the year for State.
A good design play right there, Coach Montgomery. Understanding the down and distance. Don't want to go negative like we did last week on some of those second down plays. So he called a quarterback draw right there. Great call for a first down. Auburn a little confused right here at this play call.
Batee back into the ball game for Auburn. The play clock is at 16, so time there as Thorne scrimmages from the left hash. Sends Rivaldo Fairweather in motion. Looks to the right, throws the ball to Fairweather. He's to the 45, goes airborne across the 45-yard line. They'll mark him down at the 45 for the Auburn tight end from Lauderhill, Florida, the transfer from Florida International. He gets 6 yards.
There, Rivaldo Fairweather, standing 6'4", 251 pounds. Guy used to be a former basketball player in high school, a tremendous athlete. Right there, get the ball in him to open space and let his athletic ability work.
Second and four for Auburn at the 45-yard line from the right hash. Fairweather comes in motion. Play action, throw to the sideline, complete into Mississippi State territory, down to the 45-yard line. That's Malcolm Johnson, Jr., the junior from Bryan's Road, Maryland.
Yeah, see that quick throw by Thorne right there. Ball in and out of his hand to Malcolm Johnson on the hitch, third and short.
From the 45, play action. Thorne up the seam, wide open, touchdown Auburn, touchdown Javarius Johnson.
Great throw right there by Thorne on the wheel route to Johnson right there, running down the sideline for a gain of 45 yards for a touchdown. That's what happens when you go with tempo offense and you go fast. Mississippi State defense could not get lined up to what Auburn brought out there offensively right there. Great play call, great design. We're seeing a lot more tempo and a lot more consistency here early in this ballgame.
It's the longest pass play for Auburn this season. 4:12 to go in the first quarter of play. Chapman to hold. Quattlebaum to snap it. McPherson for the extra point. Snap down, kick on the way. Right through the uprights. 4 minutes and 12 seconds to go in the first quarter of play. Auburn is 2-for-2 in its touchdown scoring drives today. Auburn 14, Mississippi State 3. And Auburn football continues in a moment.
We're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever.
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any sports fan. So make sure you... Wait, Jim, I didn't mean try it right now. We're still on the air.
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
Really?
No, not right now, Jen. We got a game to call.
Auburn family. It's Robbie Asher here. We have something special for you today. Go to onthevictory.com to enter today's giveaway for the chance to win a football helmet signed by Coach Freeze and tickets to the Iron Bowl. Enter before the final whistle. The winner will be drawn after the game. The On the Victory Collective takes care of your Auburn Tigers, and now they're taking care of you. Go to onthevictory.com. That's onthevictory.com. War Eagle.
You've created a comfortable home office. Now let Carrier provide the cash bonus. For a limited time, you can claim up to $1,550 in cool cash rebates on a qualified Carrier home comfort system. There's never been a better time to upgrade to year-round premium comfort and energy savings.
Carrier, a proud partner of Auburn Athletics and special needs assistance stations for you. Turn to the experts with Carrier.
Some people just know that a perfect football field is all about the details. Those are the people who know to choose Allstate. Take the head groundskeeper, for example.
Hands at 10 and 2. 90-degree turns, perfect stripes every time.
He knows, because he's done this 100 times. Just like he knows that paying attention on the road can save safe drivers 40% with Allstate.
Saving 40% is based on the national average premium savings for Allstate auto customers with a clean driving record versus those without. Savings vary by state and based on how you buy. Subject to terms, conditions, and availability. Allstate Fire and Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates, Northbrook, Illinois.
Today's game is brought to you by Alabama Extension, where extending knowledge means improving lives for everyone in Alabama. Visit aces.edu to learn more. Now, back to Jordan-Hare Stadium.
Sun-South John Deere drive summary for Auburn, 75 yards, 5 plays, 2 minutes and 8 seconds. Javarius Johnson on a 45-yard touchdown pass from Peyton Thorne. Auburn leads it by a score of 14-3 with 4:12 to go in the first quarter. Thorne, nice start to this one. He's 8 of 9 for 120 yards and 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, and it's a great thing right there, what you saw Auburn's offense. It was 3rd and 1, so I'm imagining Coach Freeze was going to go for it on 4th and 1 anyway, so they decided to go quickly, take a shot play right there with Johnson on a wheel route, catch the state defense off guard, and right there they did a great play design to get that ball downfield to get a touchdown right there for Johnson.
Tulu Griffin is to receive this one for Mississippi State, as Alex McPherson will kick it away. Up the left seam, and Tulu watches it bounce, and it goes out of bounds at about the 1-yard line.
Yeah, got a flag there. Yep. Ball didn't go out with the end zone.
It did not.
kicking team, number 38. The ball will be placed at the 35-yard line. First down, Mississippi State.
Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Auburn Sports Network. State first and 10 at its own 35 after the kickoff infraction by Auburn. Zion Puckett back on the field for the Tigers at safety. He went out on State's opening drive. Four on the line of scrimmage for Auburn. Davis is the tailback in the pistol behind Mike Wright from the right hash mark. Wright turns, hands the ball to Davis. Davis for 5 yards, make it six. Out to the 41-yard line for the Tigers. It's Larry Nixon, the third for Auburn, making the stop. The senior from Fort Worth, his 37th tackle of the season.
Yeah, you talk about a guy that likes to hunt the football, Andy. Larry Nixon, over 200-some tackles in his career, transfer from North Texas.
Second and four for State. Right hash mark. Thomas goes in motion. Right with a pump fake. Right now flushed out of the pocket. Looks and he throws. The flag is down. The pass is overthrown for Thomas, but again, a flag thrown. And this may be holding on Auburn.
Holding. Defense, number 36. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. The foul includes an automatic first down.
Got Auburn's Jalen Simpson.
Yeah, Jalen got caught right there in no man's land. They brought in Xavier Thomas in the motion across. They was going to run a wheel route with him. Jalen think he's running it flat right there. Decided to get the penalty rather than give up the big play.
Nose of the football just into Auburn territory at the 49-and-a-half-yard line. Simeon Price, the tailback, flanks right. Gets the ball to Price, and Price gets about a yard, and that is all. Cam Riley came up to make the stop for the Auburn Tigers. Got some help from Keldrick Falk.
Yeah, Keldrick Falk, the big signee from Auburn for Auburn this year. And also Cam Riley is a guy that we want to see a little bit more of. You know, this guy, he's long, he's athletic. You know, he can run a little bit, continue to get a nose for the football. But he can be a great specialty for this Auburn defense.
Jason Jones checks in at nose tackle, replacing Justin Roberts. On second down and 9 for State. Ball at the 58-yard line of the Tigers. Wright looks and he throws the pass to Tulu Griffin. Griffin is taken down at the 45-yard line by Cam Riley. It's going to bring up third down at about 4 for Mississippi State after the 3-yard gain.
Yeah, Mississippi State right there throwing a quick screen to the wide receiver right there, Tulu. They're one of their most explosive players on offense, trying to get the ball in his hands and get a lead blocker out in front. Third down right here coming up for Auburn. See what we like to do defensively here.
23 straight games on a catch for Tulu Griffin. Third down for the Bulldogs. Third and a long 4 with Griffin in motion. The handoff to the tailback. Stood up at the line of scrimmage and down he goes. Larry Nixon Jr., Cam Riley, and Keldrick Falk on the stop.
Yeah, big stop by the Auburn defense right there. I'm sure State was trying to catch Auburn off defense. See if we can drop back in zone. And he's going to try to run the ball right there. A little bit of a conservative call for the Mississippi State offense, but for the Auburn defense, great job of keeping your heads up and not dropping too fast, but keep your eyes on the running game as well.
Coy Moore back at the Auburn 10 to take this punt from Keelan Crimmins. 6'3", 215, a freshman from, guess, how about Australia? Auburn on top 14-3, a minute 45 and counting in the first quarter. Crimmins gets it away. End over end, Moore will let it drop, and it bounces, and it is down at the 1-yard line. Nicely played by Mississippi State.
Yeah, you couldn't ask for better punt coverage right there. Their gunner running downfield as fast as he can, able to catch that ball and not let it hit the ground right there. Auburn backed up right here. See if we continue our tempo offense, Andy, on this drive, even being backed up. We caught Mississippi State off balance a lot, especially with those linebackers that they have. We've gone away from them in the passing game.
Those of the football will be at the 3. Nobody gets you closer to the game than SiriusXM SEC Radio. Hear live games, news, analysis, and more. Visit SiriusXM.com to start listening. All right. First and 10, Auburn with its back to the end zone here. Thorne from the left hash with Jarquez Hunter to his right. Hunter, the carry, picks his way forward. Nice run, Jarquez Hunter. from the three out to the nine, a six-yard gain, before Corey Ellington makes the stop for Mississippi State.
Yeah, good job by the offensive line right there between Connor Liu and Gunnar Britton right there up front, moving that defensive tackle of Mississippi State right there, open up that back cut right there for Jarquez.
Robbie Ashford checks into the game for the first time now for the Tigers on second down and four from the hash. Hunter to Robbie's left. The snap. Peyton's going to run it. Peyton forward. He's across the 10. Peyton just bats his way out to the close to the 15-yard line. Excuse me. Robbie Ashford with the carry out to the 15-yard line. And the first down, he comes out. Thorne back in.
Yeah, Auburn still going with tempo right here. Great substitution right here after the first down, trying to get Mississippi State, get some fresh legs out there offensively, continue to put pressure on this defense, not let those guys get settled.
Auburn in the pistol with Hunter behind Thorne. First down and 10 from the 15 for the Tigers. The snap, the handoff. Jarquez stood up at the line of scrimmage. He got a couple yards, and that's about all. The stop was made by Jet Johnson.
Yeah, Jet Johnson right there, like we said, one of those guys in the SEC averaging over 10 tackles per game, him and his buddy Watson at the other linebacker position. I wouldn't be surprised if Auburn doesn't take the quarter here with 10 seconds here to go.
Final seconds are ticking away. It was a good first quarter play, perhaps the best of the season for Auburn. At the end of one, Auburn 14, Mississippi State 3. Register your child ages 5 to 12 for the Auburn Tigers kickoff kit contest from Berkshire Hathaway Home Services. Winners will see the kickoff from the sideline at Pat Dye Field, plus receive 4 game tickets, pregame VIP hospitality, a t-shirt, and video board recognition. Enter at auburnkickoffkid.com. That's auburnkickoffkid.com. At the end of one, Auburn 14, Mississippi State 3. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayBlock.
From the very beginning in 1907, Auburn Bank's mission has been to promote our community, see businesses flourish, and improve the livelihoods of local citizens. We have operated a simple and straightforward business model built on a foundation of sound business decisions and a caring response. Our local team stands ready to discuss your financial needs and goals. Auburn Bank, champions of you. Member FDIC. Online at auburnbank.com.
Auburn made here. At Jewelry by Design, we are honored to design and hand make officially licensed Auburn University jewelry. All designs are limited edition or one of a kind and made here in our store. Jewelry by Design, proudly making Auburn jewelry in Auburn. Come by to see all of our fabulous designs or let us make you one. Follow us at jbdauburn.com. War Eagle from Jewelry by Design, located at 590 North Dean Road in Auburn.
Southeastern Industrial Contractors offers the path to a productive and successful career for hard workers of all ages, especially young people looking to jump straight into the workforce. Southeastern Industrial Contractors is now hiring for great-paying, skilled trade positions. Managing partner Derek Harville is a proud Auburn University graduate with deep roots in the community. Give him a call at 334-209-6355 to learn more. Southeastern Industrial Contractors, 334-209-6355.
Come save with us. At Four Seasons Federal Credit Union, it's the time to save. The investment special is for a limited time only. Invest now and get a 7-month CD rate at 5% APR. Membership eligibility required. Dividends paid monthly. There is a penalty for early withdrawals. This certificate is non-renewable. Rates are subject to change without notice. This offer may be canceled at any time. Accounts are federally insured by the National Credit Union Administration. APR, annual percentage rate. APY, annual percentage yield. Effective July 1st, 2023.
Quarter for an Auburn team offensively in an SEC game this year. The Tigers rolled up 8 first downs, 163 yards, 2 75-yard touchdown drives for Auburn, and Auburn leads it 14-3. As we go to the second quarter, Peyton Thorne led the way. The quarterback 8 for 9 passing, 120 yards, 2 touchdowns. He also ran one time for 8 yards and a first down. This game recap sponsored by Wind Creek Casino and Hotel. With 3 Alabama locations in Atmore, Montgomery, and Wetumpka, you can escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and Hotel and at windcreekcasino.com. 14-3, Auburn leads it. We go to the second quarter. Auburn with the ball trying to punch it out from their 16-yard line. Here with the story is Andy Burcham.
All right, Paul, thank you very much. The second quarter opens with Auburn second and nine from its own 16-yard line. By the way, that touchdown in the first quarter, Auburn has now scored in 137 straight games. It's the second longest streak in school history. One, or the last time Auburn didn't score was at Alabama in 2012. Auburn 14, Mississippi State 3. Second and nine for Auburn at its own 16, ball between the hashes. Thorne from the gun hands it off to Jarquez Hunter. Hunter stood up, gets away. He's in the 20, 25, 30 down the Auburn sideline, 35, 40, and out of bounds near midfield. Boy, what a nice, patient run by Jarquez Hunter.
Yeah, Jarquez Hunter right there, a really good run behind Cam Stutz right there and big two-tall Miller on that right side of the offensive line for a gain of 31. Hunter staying patient in the hole. Coach Freeze talked about that earlier in the season, him being too fast into the hole. Coach Cadillac and Coach Freeze have talked to Hunter a little bit. Over the last couple weeks, you've seen his production go up because he's been a little bit more patient in his run game behind his offensive line.
Six carries already for 61 yards for Jarquez Hunter. First and 10 for the Tigers at the Auburn 48. Hunter again fights his way forward, 50, 45, down to the 44-yard line before he's brought down by Marcus Banks, fifth tackle of the game for Mississippi State. And Jarquez checks out, and Batie is in for Auburn at tailback.
Yeah, that thing right there for Auburn, this time they go to the left side of the offensive line, going behind Gunnar Britton and Dylan Wade. On a little bit of counter action right there backside for the Auburn Tigers.
Second and two for Auburn at the state 49-yard line. Play action, Thorne to the sideline, caught! Hollywood hooks at the 30, and a flag is down on the play.
A nice back shoulder throw.
He was guarded by DeCameron Richardson, and they may get an offensive interference.
Offense, number three. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. Remains second down.
Q Freeze would love an explanation of that call.
Yeah, I'm with Coach Freeze on that right there. That's just a great play by Shane Hooks right there and a great ball placement right there by Thorne. I didn't see anything right there to warrant an offensive pass interference. That's a bad call right there. It takes you out of great field position.
And it marches Auburn all the way back to its own 40.
Woo! Man, that was a great throw and great catch. I didn't see it. You hate to see those plays like that get taken away. Let's see the TV copy here. You don't really see a whole lot right there, no. Andy, to warrant a pass interference.
First and a long distance, 17. Excuse me, second and 17. Thorne rolls to the Auburn boundary. He throws his complete to Batie into state territory. He goes out of bounds on the Auburn sideline at the 48-yard line. Taken out of bounds by Jet Johnson. It's a gain of 12. Good chunk back. Third down and at least manageable for Auburn now.
Yeah, great play call right there. Not to be too hungry and try to get all of it at one time. Get the backfield out of the back. Put Peyton Thorne on the sprint away from the rush. Great job creating a third and manageable situation.
Damari Alston is the tailback for the Tigers. First time we've seen number 22 on the field for Auburn since he injured his shoulder at Texas A&M. It's third and six for Auburn. Auburn, one of one on third down today. Third and six. Ball at the right hash. Thorne wants to throw. Flushed out of the pocket, he throws. It's complete to Alston, but he is taken down at the 46-yard line by John Lewis.
Yeah, see if Auburn decides to go for it here. Are they going to send the punt to you now? Look, they're going to send the punt to you now, Andy, right there. Man, that drive got stalled right there by a questionable call on a pass interference. I just didn't see it, Andy, and that just slows down your offense that we felt like came out hot. Got great rhythm and tempo. The receivers and the quarterbacks are all on the same page. Tough call right there, making Auburn have to force the punt here.
Oscar Chapman will try to pin State deep. Booms it away, end over end. Thomas is back. And it's caught at the 3-yard line. That's Jalen Simpson. The gunner for the Tigers catches the ball around the 3-yard line. Nicely done by Chapman and Simpson. A 43-yard punt pins State deep. 12:04 to go in the second quarter. Auburn 14, Mississippi State 3. State pinned back at its own 3 when play resumes. Auburn football continues in a moment.
Sports not only bring us together, they inspire us on our own health journeys. Whether we're walking an extra lap, crushing a new goal, or spending time with friends cheering in the stands, we all win when we feel healthier and happier. That's why Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama is a proud sponsor of athletic programs across the state. Because a healthier Alabama is a happier Alabama. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama.
We cover what matters.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
What widens the eyes, tightens the stomach, and flutters the heart, adrenaline. Feel it for yourself in the Toyota RAV4, Camry, Corolla, and Tacoma. Get 2.9% APR for 36 months on a new 2023 Toyota RAV4. Toyota, let's go places. Offer valid through October 31st, 2023. $0 for well-qualified buyers with approved credit and financing through Southeast Toyota Finance. $29.04 monthly payment for $1,000 financed. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fees. See dealer for details.
Auburn fans, this is Coach Hugh Freeze asking for your help. On to Victory has been a crucial supporter of Auburn student athletes. It's important to keep that good work going, so please join On to Victory today, War Eagle.
.12:04 to go in the second quarter. Auburn 14, Mississippi State 3. State first and 10 at its own 3-yard line. Mike Wright, the quarterback for State, made the first start for State at quarterback other than Will Rogers in 38 games last week in that 7-3 win over the Razorbacks. And Will Rogers in street clothes today as Mike Wright gets his second consecutive start for the Bulldogs. Auburn. And now pinned to the student section right behind him.
Yeah, and it's about to get loud right here. The Auburn defense is third in the SEC in turnover margin. See if we can create a turnover. Mississippi State back up in the hole here.
Pittman in the pistol behind Wright on first and 10 from the 3. Pittman up the middle and taken down at the line of scrimmage. Knifing through Eugene Asante with the ankle tackle.
Yeah, Eugene Asante right there coming unblocked, running through the A gap as a linebacker. Basically a run blitz is what it is. Good job coming up, making the tackle, making sure that Pippen can't get out of it.
Loss of one, back to the 2, second and 11 for Mississippi State. Thomas wide right, Robinson wide left. State scrimmages from the left hash mark. From the Auburn, or from the State 2. Right, play action. Looks to the sideline. He's going to run it. He's got room. He's out to the 10 and taken down at the 15-yard line.
Jalen McLeod right there and Austin Keys kind of got caught up in the wash right there. Both guys went inside. One guy has got to loop outside and keep contained right there. Both guys lost containment. Mike Wright able to get outside right there and pick up a gain of a big yardage for the first down for State.
13-yard gain out to the 15. First and 10 for State from the 15-yard line. Tula Griffin is the tailback. He goes in motion. They run the reverse near side. Nicely played by Auburn, but a good job by Xavier Thomas. Second effort. He gets from the 15. He's taken down at the 20-yard line. Well, it looked like Auburn was going to get him at the line, but Thomas jetted forward out to the 20.
Yeah, a little jet action in the backfield right there by Xavier Thomas. Mike Wright giving that ball to him, going out the back door right there. Looked like Auburn's going to have him tackle for a loss, but he did a great job right there, keeping his legs moving, falling forward for positive yards.
Double wide receivers to the wide side of the field for State. They're off the line of the end zone. Second and 5 from the 20. Davis the tailback. Wright's going to run it to the boundary. Taken down after a 1-yard gain. Stop made by Jalen McLeod for the Tigers. It's going to bring up 3rd and 4 for Mississippi State. He ran to the short side of the field. McLeod corralled him.
Yeah, great job right there, Jalen McLeod. Staying back home. Andy, we talked about that in the pregame show. You can't overflow if you're a defensive end or a linebacker in this game. If you're backside, you got to keep your eyes open for the backside run by Mike Wright. Creating a 3rd down situation right here, 3rd and 5. Auburn looks to be in man defense here.
State is 0-for-3 on 3rd down today. Davis the tailback to the left of Wright. Wright rolls to his right, looking to throw, still looking, throws it up the boundary and complete into the sideline. He threw into double coverage.
Yeah, great coverage right there by the Auburn defense.
right there on the backside, playing that man coverage we talked about, Andy. Good job of making sure everybody stick with your man. No one coming off to come up and make the tackle on Mike Wright, understanding the down and situation. Great job by the Auburn defense right here to force a punt, give Auburn great field position right here. We were able to receive this punt.
State now 0-4 on third down today. And Keelan Crimmins is out to punt it away with Coy Moore back at the Auburn 39. Good snap. Crimmins gets it away. Moore comes up to the 40, to the Auburn boundary, 45, and out of bounds near midfield. Nice return by Coy Moore gives Auburn terrific field position. 9:15 to go in the second quarter of play. 39-yard punt, 10-yard return. Auburn first and 10 from the 48 when we return. The Tigers lead the Bulldogs 14-3. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Get your game day started with the Auburn Sports Network and the Tiger Tailgate Show, presented by Kaneka Sausage. Paul Ellen, Brad Law, Andy Burcham, Ronnie Brown, Will Herring, and Jason Campbell bring the tailgate party to you. Breakdowns of the games from every angle, visits from former Tiger greats, and updates from around campus 3 hours before kickoff of every Auburn game. It's the biggest tailgate party on the radio. The Tiger Tailgate Show, presented by Kaneka Sausage.
Things we take for granted, ordinary opportunities for parents and their children, can be a foster child's extraordinary. You have the power to do something positive that will change the life of a young person right here in Alabama. Open your heart and open your home to a foster child today. For more information, visit www.dhr.alabama.gov or call 1-866-4AL-KIDS. Brought to you by the Alabama Department of Human Resources, the Alabama Broadcasters Association, and this station.
Sports not only bring us together, they inspire us on our own health journeys. Whether we're walking an extra lap, crushing a new goal, or spending time with friends cheering in the stands, we all win when we feel healthier and happier. That's why Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama is a proud sponsor of athletic programs across the state. Because a healthier Alabama is a happier Alabama. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Alabama. We cover what matters.
By now, your daily routine is probably a little too routine. Don't you want to change? Don't you want to start playing by your own rules and escape the routine so your fantasy becomes reality? Where every night is an adventure, where new flavors are ready to be tasted, where it feels like you're a winner. Take a chance. Reward yourself. Make your routine anything but routine. Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
Can we get some brats?
We'll work on those brats for you there, Jason. 9:15 to go, second quarter. That'd be delicious.
Man, I tell you, right now, I'm telling you, if I wasn't calling this game with Andy Burcham today, I'd probably be by a green egg with some brats and some burgers and hot dogs. But I like where I'm at right here with Andy Burcham calling
the game. It'd be Kaneka Sausage, I guarantee you that.
Hey, I'm telling you, man, got some good elk last night.
Well, there you go. Why don't we go back to the field? 14-3 Auburn, 9:15 to go. In the first half of play, Tiger ball at the Auburn 48. Damari Alston, the tailback.
Free play,
Thorne. Up the sideline or up the seam, and the ball is incomplete. Intended for Javarius Johnson. Auburn actually threw into triple coverage to Carlos Nicholson, but a flag is down.
Defense, number 91. In the neutral zone of the snap, 5-yard penalty. Remains first down.
Peyton Thorne is 10 of 12, 134 yards and 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, very efficient right there in that first quarter by this whole offense. Ball getting in and out of his hands quickly.
First and 5 for Auburn at the state 47. Thorne looks to the sideline. Alston flanks him to the right. Thorne, play action. Thorne up the seam and incomplete. Flag is down. He was trying to go to number 10, Caleb Burton III, but was held. This is either going to be holding or interference on state.
Holding. Defense, number 7. 10-yard penalty from the previous spot. The penalty includes an automatic first down.
Safety Sean Preston called for the infraction, a grad student out of St. James, Louisiana.
You see why he grabbed him as well. You watch the TV copy here. If he doesn't grab Caleb Burton, a fast guy, transfer from Ohio State, that may be a touchdown for Auburn right there. So he decided to take the penalty rather than give up a touchdown.
First and 10 for the Tigers. Ball at the 37 of Mississippi State. Thorne hands it. Damari Alston makes a nice move, moves forward inside the 35 to the 31-yard line. 5 yards on the game, brought down by Deshaun Page.
Yeah, good to see Damari Alston in the game, running the football back on the field for Auburn. He's really good in the run game, but also in pass protection. He's done a good job of picking up Mississippi State stunts.
Thorne, 10 of 11. He's thrown to 9 different receivers. He's going to keep it around the left end, spins at the 30, gets down to the 26. And an Auburn first down. Deontay Anderson, defensive end out of Miami on the stop. But that's a first down carry by Peyton Thorne.
Yeah, Peyton Thorne right there on the quarterback keeper, reading the defensive end, keeping the ball right there. Took a big shot right there from Anderson on the spin.
Troops checking in and out of the Auburn and Mississippi State lineups. First down for the Tigers from the state 27. Thorne, ball in the middle of the field. Rolls to his right, the Auburn boundary. Now stops, he looks, he throws. Incomplete. Oh, goodness. He had Caleb Burton wide open at the 12-yard line.
Yeah, Caleb Burton running that deep over route right there. Looked to the flat, didn't have Fairweather, didn't have Hollywood Hooks. Good job of bringing his eyes back to his third guy in the progression. Just got to get that ball down a little bit right there for Caleb.
Burton got a hand on the ball but couldn't bring it in. Second and 10 for Auburn at the state 27. Double wide receivers right and left for the Tigers. Fairweather and Deal both in the slots right and left. Now Fairweather in motion to the Auburn boundary. Play action, rollout. Throw the ball to Fairweather. Fairweather makes a move, gets to the 21-yard line. He's brought down by Sean Preston.
Yeah, I like that play design right there, Andy. Do a good job. We're not getting too hungry where we're trying to get all of the first down. Just get some of it back to make it a third and manageable situation for this offense, which helps us be more efficient.
Third and 4 from the state 21. State with some movement. Thorne throws to the boundary. It's complete and dropped by Shane Hooks at the 5.
Yeah, I thought there was movement on the defensive line right there by State. Thought it was going to be a free play.
I'm with you, Jason.
I guess the refs didn't see what we saw up here, Andy. But right there, great throw right there. I feel like Hollywood Hooks could have got backside right there to catch that ball. But great play by the Mississippi State defense.
This will be a 39-yard field goal attempt by Alex McPherson. Just inside the right hash, out of the hole to Chapman, the snap of Quattlebaum. The snap down, kick is on the way, and the kick is good. 13 straight made field goals by Alex McPherson, the freshman out of Fort Payne, Alabama. And with 7 minutes and 18 seconds to go in the second quarter, Auburn adds to the lead. Tigers 17, Mississippi State 3. Auburn football continues in a moment.
We've all fallen into boring routines. We just keep doing what has to get done. Isn't it time to escape the old routine and make time for yourself? Make time to go out with old friends. Make time to add excitement back into your life. Make time to feel like a winner again. Life is more fun when you live it. So what are you waiting for? Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
Hey, I'm Charles Barkley. Call for a Redmont and water at bars and restaurants throughout the great state of Alabama. Redmont Vodka, available at select ABC stores and package stores. Redmont Vodka is 8 times distilled, gluten-free, and is made from non-GMO corn. Looking to support a local business? Redmont Distilling is Alabama proud and minority-owned. Learn more online at redmontdistilling.com.
Some people just know the perfect time to hit the concession stand. Those are the people who know to choose Allstate.
Woo! Nice! I never miss a touchdown. Want a bite?
Yeah, he knows he's got a sixth sense for a snack break. Just like he knows that switching to Allstate can save drivers $468.
Saving $468 is based on the national average annual savings for new auto customers surveyed in 2022 who switched to Allstate. Prices may vary based on how you buy. Allstate Fire and Casualty Insurance Company and affiliates, Northbrook, Illinois.
Tackle your to-do list this season and find the right Aetna Medicare plan for you in your home state of Alabama. With Aetna Medicare Advantage plans, you can get a $0 monthly plan premium with hospital, medical, and prescription drug coverage. Plans also include dental, vision, and an over-the-counter benefit. Be the star quarterback of your health. Call us for a personalized coverage review now. 1-833-771-7542. TTY-711. Aetna Medicare is an HMO PPO plan with a Medicare contract. RSNPs also have contracts with state Medicaid programs. Enrollment in our plans depends on contract renewal. Plan features and availability may vary by service area.
Today's game between the Tigers and Bulldogs is presented by Alabama Extension, where extending knowledge means improving lives for everyone in Alabama. Visit aces.edu to learn more. Now, back to Jordan-Hare for more of Auburn and Mississippi State.
Second quarter action, Auburn 17, Mississippi State 3. Down to the field, Cook's Pest Control sideline report with Ronnie Brown.
All right, guys. Mississippi State, or let me say, Auburn's done a great job holding Mississippi State, not allowing them to run the football. So they haven't had a lot of success running the football. So I would look for them to try to utilize Mike Wright as the quarterback, try to use his legs a little bit. We saw it on that last drive. Fortunately for Auburn, they were able to get him off the field, were able to go down and get them 3 points. But I would expect some play-action stuff and then trying to utilize the quarterback a little bit more because they haven't been able to establish the run with backup running back. With their backup running back.
Yeah, Mike Wright, 5 carries, 13 yards for State, kickoff into the end zone for the Tigers. Sun-South John Deere Drive summary, 31 yards, 6 plays, 1:57. Alex McPherson's 39-yard field goal gives Auburn a 17-3 lead. Sun-South John Deere, preferred tractor of the Tigers. Find your local dealer, sunsouth.com. Right now, Auburn dominating the scoreboard and the stats. 233 yards total offense for Auburn, Jason, only 95 for Mississippi State.
Yeah, Auburn's done a really good job and in containing this Mississippi State offense. They came out trying to take some shots, hit us deep a little bit, caught us in some man coverage situations. Here lately, we've been too safe to feel like we stopped the run.
Pittman in the backfield in the pistol behind Wright on first and 10 from the 25 play action. Wright drops deep to throw, throws it up the seam. Almost intercepted. Nehemiah Pritchett was the closest one there. Intended receiver was Justin Robinson.
Yeah, Justin Robinson running that deep post route right there. Nehemiah Pritchett running with him step for step right there. That ball got to be thrown a little bit more across the field for the offensive receiver, but great coverage by Nehemiah Pritchett right there against the big receiver, 6'4", for Mississippi State Robinson.
Right now, 4 of 8 for 46 yards passing. Here's second and 10 for the Bulldogs. Again, out of the pistol from the right hash. Double wide receivers, wide side of the field for Mississippi State. Wright turns, hands the ball to the tailback right up the middle, and he gets out to the 34-yard line before he's brought down. Nice carry by Jeffrey Pittman out of Taylorsville, Mississippi, before Champ Anthony brings him down for the Tigers.
Yeah, Champ Anthony, one of those guys that gets a lot of playing time coming in, do a really good job of filling in. I think he's filling in right now for Jalen Simpson, also as well on defense. Well, out on defense right now, but you also got to continue. This defense can turn up a little bit pressure on this third and one right here. Look for an RPO game by Mike Wright.
State 0-4 on third down today. Third and actually 2. Hand off, play action. Wright throws it, incomplete. They had 2 receivers, and the only one there for the Tigers was DJ James. Yeah, Jordan Mosley and Freddie Robertson. And Jordan Mosley were the 2 receivers there for State.
Yeah, definitely like some miscommunication right there offensively, because if they'd have handed that ball off right there, their running back might have hit his head on the goalpost. I'm glad he didn't, but right there, like you said, Andy, 2 receivers in the same area. DJ James had to make the decision to choose one of those guys. Fortunate enough for us, we was able to get off the field.
3 and out for the Auburn defense. 3 and out tracker driven by Truckworks, official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Crimmins to punt it away. Coy Moore back for Auburn. Punt is away, driving a Coy Moore back. He lets it bounce. It bounces sideways, and it is down at the 13-yard line for Mississippi State. Good punt by Keelan Crimmins. 6:18 to go in the second quarter of play. A 54-yard punt by the Melbourne Australia native. Auburn 17, Mississippi State 3. CBNS Bank has been family, community, and financially strong since they began in 1906. Visit cbsbank.com. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playpoint.
Live Sports Radio, bringing you all the action of game day with no delay. Every touchdown, interception, sideline report, and all the analysis from Andy Burcham, Jason Campbell, Ronnie Brown, and Will Herring. Yours at home and on the road. And they're good all through the spring. When football ends, you can still hear every broadcast of home men's and women's basketball, baseball, and softball, all with no delay. Live Sports Radio and Alpha Insurance, keeping you plugged into the Tigers at home and on the road.
What widens the eyes, tightens the stomach, and flutters the heart. Adrenaline. Feel it for yourself in the Toyota RAV4, Camry, Corolla, and Tacoma.
Lease a new 2023 Toyota RAV4 LE for $319 a month for 36 months. Toyota, let's go places. Offer valid through October 31st, 2023. Well-qualified lessees with approved credit through Southeast Toyota Finance. 3618 due at signing. No security deposit with select equipment. $350 disposition fee. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fee. See dealer for details.
When the game goes into overtime, but the game goes into overtime, the choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
When you see the SEC student athlete, it's easy to picture the swing, the stance, the form. But look closer, and you'll see the heart, the brain, the clutch lab partner, the avid two-stepper, the pride of a hometown, and a little brother's hero. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
Jordan-Hare Stadium to check the Yellowwood scoreboard. An incomplete pass in the end zone, and number six Oklahoma goes down in Lawrence. Kansas beat them 38-33. We'll update all the scores for you coming up at halftime on the Truck Works Halftime Report. Andy?
6:18 to go in the second quarter here. Paul, Tigers on top of Mississippi State 17-3. First and 10, Auburn at its own 13 after the 54-yard punt by the state punter Crimmins. Jarquez Hunter, the tailback for the Tigers. Auburn brings Fromm in motion. Jarquez Hunter with the carry. Boy, he is taken down at the 10-yard line. That was Jet Johnson jetting in to make the stop on Jarquez.
Yeah, you're exactly right there, Andy. Jet Johnson looked like a jet shooting through that hole right there, making that hit on Jarquez before he can get started north and south.
Second and 12, a 2-yard loss, one of the few losses for the Tigers offensively in this first half. Ball back at the 11, clock rolling with 5:50 to go in the second quarter. That's, as a matter of fact, that's Auburn's first negative play of the game.
Yeah, Ashford in the game.
Ashford, the quarterback. Play action, he'll keep it. And Ashford gets 2 yards, maybe three, before he's brought down on the play. Ashford taken down by number seven, Sean Preston, the grad student from St. James, Louisiana. And here's third down for Auburn. The Tigers are 1 of 3. On third down today.
Yeah, it's a big third down for Auburn right here, because you're backed up. If you don't get this, you're going to get Mississippi State good field position right here. Big key first, key third down here for Auburn.
Thorne flanked by Hunter. Sends Fromm in motion out of the backfield and movement.
Hey, I get Dylan Wade.
False start. Offense, number 52. 5-yard penalty, remains third down.
Second movement penalty today on Dylan. Junior out of Houston, transfer from Tulsa.
Yeah, anytime you see a stem by a defense like that, offensive line got to hold your water a little bit longer and understand that the defense is going to make those stems. See what Auburn does here in a third and long situation backed up.
Third and 16 back at the 7. Thorne with 12 on the play clock. Now moves Jarquez to his left. Play clock is at 6. Handoff goes to Jarquez Hunter. And Jarquez gets about 2 yards, and that is all. And Auburn will punt it away.
Yeah, that false start penalty right there, you know, put you backed up in a situation where Auburn, you got a 17-3 lead. Don't want to do anything to give Mississippi State a freebie right here before the half. But Mississippi State will get good field position,
yes,
right
will.
Here.
And they've got Xavier Thomas back to return this, and he's at midfield to take this punt as the Auburn fans do the wave behind Oscar Chapman. To his right, and he gets it away. End over end, Thomas lets it bounce. It takes an Auburn roll into Mississippi State territory and is down at the 48-and-a-half yard line by the snapper, Reed Hughes. Hughes on the punts, Jacob Quattobaum on the field goals and extra points. 44-yard punt, but good field position, the best of the day starting for State at the 48-yard line with 4:02 to go in the second quarter. And Auburn leading Mississippi State 17-3.
And the good thing about Auburn defense is we lead the SEC in red zone defense. So Auburn knows how to be stingy, even in these situations right here, if Mississippi State is able to get to the red zone.
First and 10 for State at its own 48-4 on the line of scrimmage for the Tigers. Auburn rushes 5, handoff, tailback, gets across midfield, 45, head down to the 43-yard line. Jalen Simpson made the stop, but is slow to get up. Gets some help, and he is up off the turf.
Yeah, big run by Seth Davis right there for Mississippi State. Good job blocking that offensive side of the left side right there. Auburn defense was in a three-man front on that left side right there. I mean, the right side for our defense, creating that hole right there, a gap for Mississippi State.
Second and one from the Auburn 43, left hash mark. Right turns, hands the ball to Davis. He's got the first down, head down inside the 40. Off the right side to the 39-yard line. Host of Auburn Tiger tacklers there, including Eugene Asante and Jason Jones.
Yeah, Jason Jones, that big defensive tackle right there, big tall man in the middle right there. He's a big guy to move, Andy.
Transfer out of Oregon. State on the move right now. First and 10 at the Auburn 39. Ball in the middle of the field. Davis flanks right. Man comes in motion across the line of scrimmage. Sets up outside the right tackle. Now back to the left side of the line of scrimmage for State. Right looks to the State boundary, throws an incomplete. Voice of miscommunication. Xavier Thomas was running downfield, never turned around. The ball landed 5 yards behind him. He was blocking on the play.
Yeah, that's twice that Mississippi State has had confusion on the passing game between the quarterback and the receivers. Two people in the same spot. This time, man, blocking downfield, not even looking for the football. Something I'm pretty sure their head coach is going to be going bananas about at halftime. But this is a big, big play right here for Auburn defense on third down.
Second and 10 for State. At the Auburn 39. Right rolls to his left, moves forward. Right down to the 32-yard line. Eugene Asante is there for the Tigers.
Yeah, what Mississippi State is doing, Andy, right now they're trying to work that clock as well. They don't want to give Auburn an opportunity to try to go down the field and get points before the half, knowing that Mississippi State receives the ball after halftime. So they're trying to work the clock all the way down while they're trying to push the ball downfield. Right here, third and two, got to be alert defensively for anything backside with Mike Wright or anything in the flat.
Third and two from the Auburn 32. Actually, it's third and three for State. Wright hands the ball to the tailback Pittman. Wright brings it to the left side. And Wright goes down at the 30. He's still going to be yard shy of the first down.
Yeah, I think his knee hit the ground before getting that first down. Going to make it a fourth and short right here.
Just got inside the 30. And it's going to be fourth and one for State. And the Bulldogs will go for it. State 1 of 1 today on fourth down. They're 7 of 14 this season on fourth down. A minute 33 and counting to go in the first half of play. Yeah, Auburn 17, Mississippi State 3. State may run this down and call a timeout. They're still in the huddle, and the play clock is at 6. And there is the timeout called by State. Stopping the clock with a minute 18 to go in the second quarter of play. Auburn on top of Mississippi State 17-3. Auburn scored on its first three drives, two touchdown passes by Peyton Thorne on the first two drives.
Yeah, Auburn's done a really good job moving the ball, especially in that first quarter, getting the 14 points right there. Right here for our Auburn defense, you saw Harris in the game right there, Marcus Harris. They also saw Justin Rogers there as well. You got Kedrick Falcon at defensive front. Big third and one. Auburn trying to get some of their big guys in the middle right there to try to keep Mississippi State from running the ball up through the middle.
And but right you, with right in the game, they've got some options.
Yeah, they got some
for
options.
For fourth and one.
So McAllister got to be careful here backside, him and McLeod, whichever way this ball go, to make sure that Wright doesn't keep the ball and pull it out the back door.
Ball is just inside the left hash mark. State needs a yard on fourth down at the Auburn 30. Xavier Thomas splits wide right. Justin Robinson in the slot to the Auburn boundary. Wright, the quarterback, hands the ball. No, it's right around the right side. He goes down back at the 32. Jalen McLeod came up. Wright lost his footing, and Auburn gets the ball on downs.
Yeah, but exactly what we talked about, Andy. Stay home backside if you want those backside ends, just in case Mike Wright keeps the ball, decided not to hand that ball off and kept it. Good job of staying home right there, making a tackle on fourth down, turnover on downs for Mississippi State.
All right, a minute 14 to go in the half. Remember, Auburn has all three timeouts remaining in the half, leading 17-3.
Yeah, Auburn can take their time here and get the ball down the field. You don't have to take a shot early because you said, Andy, we got three timeouts, but getting out of bounds saves some of those timeouts as well.
Malcolm Johnson Jr. splits to the boundary. Auburn hands it off to the tailback, Jarquez Hunter, Oss across the 35 to the 37-yard line. Don Terry Russell with the stop for State. Russell, the Sam linebacker, a redshirt freshman from Jackson. Auburn right back to the line. Snap to Thorne. Lots of time. Now flush to the Auburn boundary. Thorne looks and he just throws it away. Stopping the clock with 50 seconds to go in the second quarter. It's third and four for Auburn at the 38.
Yeah, Thorne got to understand in that situation right there that if you don't have anything that you like, don't waste time off the clock moving around. Time is an essence. Just throw that ball away and get to the next down.
So this is third and four for Auburn from the Tiger 38-yard line. Thorne looks to the Auburn sideline. Play clock is down to 15. Jarquez Hunter flanks him to the right. Thorne wants to throw it. Short drop, looks, throws. Ball deflected and caught. Caught by Javarius Johnson. He dives across midfield into Mississippi State territory. 13 yards and a first down.
A great focus right there by Javarius Johnson. Ball over the middle, got tipped. Auburn takes a timeout.
Stopping the clock, 42 seconds to go in the second quarter. First and 10 for Auburn at the State 48-yard line. I'm not sure who deflected the ball at the line of scrimmage, but good concentration by the senior out of Hewitt-Trussville High School in Trussville, Alabama, Javarius Johnson.
Yeah, I think when our defensive lineman stopped right there on his pass rush and decided to jump up and tip that ball right there for Mississippi State.
But fluttered right to the Auburn receiver. Camden Brown, a one of three receivers to the wide side of the field, the State boundary. Malcolm Johnson Jr., the lone receiver, split to the Auburn boundary. First down for the Tigers. They rush four. Thorne flushed out of the pocket. Now pulls up, throws. Ball complete, first down. Rivaldo Fairweather gets 11 yards and a first down for the Tigers.
Yeah, great pass protection right there by the Auburn offensive line right there. Good job of keeping those guys up the middle, able to get a pass rush on Thorne, able to go through his progressions, find Fairweather on the sidelines.
33 seconds to go in the first half of play. First down for Auburn. Thorne out of an empty set. Looks to run it. Nope, he throws it and throws it away. The closest was Camden Brown for the Tigers.
Yeah, good throwaway right there by Thorne. Covered pretty well by Mississippi State. Still got 28 seconds on the clock, but you got two timeouts.
So it will be second down for the Tigers, second and 10 from the State 37-yard line. Clock stop with 28 seconds to go in the quarter. Hooks wide right. Kelly is there as well. 28 seconds to go in the half. Thorne rolls to the Auburn boundary, throws it. Jarquez Hunter, 35. He makes a man miss, hurdles a man at the 20, goes out of bounds at the 15-yard line.
Yeah, the most important thing he did right there, Andy, was getting out of bounds, stopping the clock, which saves your two timeouts in your pocket if you still have them with 20 seconds to go. Gain of 21 right there.
Auburn in the Chick-fil-A red zone with 20 seconds to go in the half. Double wide receivers right and left. Jarquez, who showed his hurdling abilities on that pitch and catch, flanks Thorne to his left. First down for Auburn at the state 16-yard line. Play clock is at 4. Down to 2. There's the snap. Thorne, quarterback draw. Thorne to the Auburn boundary. Thorne inside the 10. Clock stopped with 14 seconds to go. An 8-yard gain for Peyton Thorne in the QB draw.
Yeah, good job of getting out of bounds right there again. Moving in positive yards, leaving 14 seconds on the clock. Give you an opportunity, maybe 3 shots to the end zone because you still have your timeouts left.
Second and 1 for Auburn. The ball will be snapped from the 7-yard line. And Auburn brings Jeremiah Cobb into the lineup along with Camden Brown. Both teams with substitutions now. Double wide receivers right and left. Cobb flanks Thorne. Second and 1 from the state 7-yard line. Thorne drops, looks, floats it. Cobb has it! Touchdown! Jeremiah Cobb, a 7-yard strike from Thorne, who threw it perfectly. Touchdown, Auburn!
Yes, love the play call right there by Coach Freeze and Coach Montgomery. Caught Mississippi State in man coverage. Cobb lined up in the backfield in the running back position, was able to outrun Dontarius Russell to the end zone right there. Great pass over the left shoulder by Peyton Thorne to Jeremiah Cobb for a touchdown. Great drive by the Auburn offense to score points right before the half.
Jeremiah Cobb on a dandy teardrop pass from Peyton Thorne, his 3rd touchdown of the first half. And now McPherson is out for the extra point. Snap on the way. It's good. The kick is good. Remember, this drive started when State went for it on 4th down and McLeod corralled right. And the Auburn offense only needed 1 timeout during that drive to score the touchdown. And with 9 seconds to go in what has been a tremendous first half of play for the Tigers, Auburn leads Mississippi State 24-3. Sun South, John Deere drive summary. 68 yards, 8 plays, 1:05. Jeremiah Cobb, a 7-yard touchdown catch from Peyton Thorne. Thorne in the first half, 15 of 20, 192 yards, 3 touchdowns in the first half. He has thrown to 10 different receivers in the first half of play.
Yeah, he spread the ball around really well. This offensive staff has done a really good job this week of understanding, like, hey, let's get more guys involved in the game plan. They got Thorne going early in the game by hitting some quick hitters, those hitches, those slant routes, those quick out routes, got him into a rhythm early. This offense has beginning to flow. This is what our fans, this is what people kind of anticipated they was going to see in this offense this year. Like the tempo, like the speed of this offense so far in this first half.
McPherson will kick it away. Tulu Griffin back at the 1. It's a low line drive kick, and it is a downed at the 30 or the 26. Tigers have scored in a Chick-fil-A red zone, which means a free offer for everyone in the Chick-fil-A app. Download or log into your Chick-fil-A app to claim a free offer before midnight tonight. Redeemed by scanning or placing a mobile order next Monday through Friday at participating Alabama Chick-fil-A restaurants. 8 seconds in the first half. State ball first and 10. With Auburn leading State by a score of 24-3. Ball is marked at the 26. And State will take a knee. And that first half of play comes to a close. Auburn started and finished strongly. Auburn 24, Mississippi State 3. Let's go down to Ronnie Brown, who's standing by with Auburn head coach Hugh Freeze.
All right, coach, offensively, you were off to a great start. We're able to put the ball in the end zone early. Tell me about it.
Yeah, I'm just really proud of our kids. You know, they just executing the plan really well, playing solid at quarterback, and receivers are making some plays, which is encouraging to see. So, good first half. I think you could have got a few more points. I thought we had a bad call here on the interference, but really proud of our kids.
Defensively, been able to stop the run and kept them out of the end zone. What was the message to the defensive guys?
Yeah, that's big after the first drive, man. Just settle in and challenging them after we got 14. We got enough to win the game as good as y'all can play, so let's do it.
All right, coach, message going in the half. Good luck. hey, as you heard it, guys, offensively, been able to stay on top of it. Unfortunately, got a bad call, wasn't able to get a drive and get that together, but have been able to recover and do a really good job. Defensively, they're doing a good job.
All right, Ronnie, Peyton Thorne in the first half, 15 of 20, 192 yards. He threw to 11 different receivers in the half. The score, Auburn 24, Mississippi State 3. Now Paul Ellen with the Truckworks halftime report.
All right, Andy, a 300-yard first half for the Auburn offense. Let's check the top 25 scoreboard first on the Truckworks halftime report. Florida went right down the field with the opening possession in Jacksonville. Graham Mertz, 5 for 5. They led 7-0, and that was the end of the Gator hopes. Georgia has scored on a field goal, 3 touchdowns, and a blocked punt safety. It is 26-7. Georgia leads in the middle of the second period. Elsewhere around the top 25, number 7, Texas, leading BYU 14-3 as they play late in the second quarter in Austin. Bo Nix off to a good start in Utah as number 8, Oregon, leads 13th-ranked Utah 21-3. They are nearing the end of the half. Utah threatening to score at the Oregon 12-yard line with just 19 seconds to go. 14th-ranked Notre Dame leads Pittsburgh 14-0. They are also playing near the end of the first half, and they just tacked on a field goal with less than 15 seconds to go. So Notre Dame now leads it 17-0. Louisville, ranked number 18, leading number 20, Duke, 17-0. They're at halftime in Louisville. And number 22, Tulane, leading at Rice, 17-7. Also number 24, Southern Cal, leading Cal 17-14 as they play in Berkeley. They are just starting the second quarter, so a wild first quarter in that one. That's your top 25 scoreboard. We'll give you the story of this one with Auburn leading 24-3 over Mississippi State at halftime. Stay with us. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
This is Greg Bell, radio voice of the Scottsboro Wildcats. For complete coverage of Wildcat athletics, tune in to 1050 WWIC in Scottsboro. Football, boys and girls basketball, baseball, and softball. Nobody provides better coverage of the Scottsboro Wildcats than WWIC Radio. For all things Scottsboro Wildcats, tune in to WWIC 1050 AM and WWICRadio.com. Scottsboro Wildcat Radio.
War Eagle, it's a great day for Auburn Tigers to get vaccinated. Many children and adults that delayed vaccinations during the pandemic are still behind schedule. It's crucial that we take steps to get everyone back on track with their routine immunizations. Children and teens can still catch up on their vaccinations even if they start late. Make sure you and your family are all up to date on all recommended vaccines, including COVID-19 and flu. Let's all do our part to get back on track. Don't wait. Vaccinate. For more information, visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM.
Yellowwood knows that a 5-star backyard is the place to make lasting memories, like cookouts, cornhole with friends. Ooh, a neighborhood potluck with your wife's pasta salad, the one with the feta. Oh, sorry. Or taking a nap on your deck in a hammock. Naps are memories. I love naps. For 5-star backyards and the most memorable experiences, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
What widens the eyes, tightens the stomach, and flutters the heart. Adrenaline. Feel it for yourself in the Toyota RAV4, Camry, Corolla, and Tacoma. Get 2.9% APR for 36 months on a new 2023 Toyota RAV4. Toyota, let's go places. Offer valid through October 31st, 2023. $0 down for well-qualified buyers with approved credit and financing through Southeast Toyota Finance. $29.04 monthly payment for every $1,000 financed. Excludes tax, tag, registration, title, and dealer fees. See dealer for details.
A shootout today at Jordan-Hare Stadium.
This is the Truckworks Halftime Report. Visit truckworks.com to learn more about the company or to learn about career opportunities with Truckworks. Back to Paul Ellen.
Bit of a shootout today at Jordan-Hare Stadium and something of a surprise. Auburn against Mississippi State. Not a lot of punting as both teams moved the ball effectively. In fact, Auburn moved it extremely effectively. Time for the story of the first half is called by Andy Burcham. Auburn took the opening kickoff, moved from their 25-yard line. They converted a third down and then had the ball inside the 30-yard line of Mississippi State, where Peyton Thorne went to work.
Second and three for the Tigers. Back to the line of scrimmage. Play action. Thorne looks. And he has Hollywood hooks. He dives to the end zone. Touchdown, Auburn! Touchdown, Auburn!
That capped an eight-play, 75-yard drive in just 3.5 minutes in. Auburn led it 7-0. Mississippi State, though, with an answer. Their first play of their first possession, a 33-yard pass, put him in Auburn territory. A fourth and one was converted on a 2-yard run inside the Auburn red zone, but the drive stalled out there, and Kyle Faree kicked a 29-yard field goal to make it 7-3, Auburn leading 65 yards on the drive on 11 plays. Auburn came right back, though, from their 25-yard line after the kickoff. They moved steadily up to midfield, and there Thorne went to the air again.
From the 45, play action, Thorne up the seam, wide open, touchdown Auburn, touchdown Javarius Johnson.
That was 5 plays, 75 yards, and Auburn led it 14-3 with 4 minutes to go in the first period. Mississippi State got a first down, but then could not move the ball, got a great punt downed inside the Auburn 5-yard line. Auburn got the ball out a little bit as Jerquez Hunter with a 31-yard run got him out to the from the 16-yard line, but a first down was called back on an offensive pass interference penalty that you heard Coach Freeze discuss there, and the Tigers had to punt the ball away. They backed State up to their 3-yard line, and State, after one first down, had to punt it away. Auburn got good field position at the midfield area. They moved for a couple of first downs, and then Alec McPherson came on with a 39-yard field goal to make it 17-3 Auburn. 6-play, 31-yard drive. Couple of pass drops on that drive kept Auburn from converting more. State went 3 and out. Auburn got the ball from the 13, but the Tigers couldn't move, and they went 3 and out. Only time in the first half, Auburn was 3 and out. Mississippi State moving from near midfield, and they tried to move it upfield, eventually going for it on a 4th down. Big play for the Auburn defense.
State needs a yard on 4th down at the Auburn 30. Xavier Thomas looks wide right. Justin Robinson in the slot to the Auburn boundary. Right, the quarterback, hands the ball. No, it's right around the right side. He goes down, back at the 32. Jalen McLeod came up. Wright lost his footing, and Auburn gets the ball on downs.
Yep. That was a big play, because it came with a minute 14 to go in the half, gave Auburn the ball at their 32-yard line. Tigers wasted little time converting. They moved for 4 quick first downs, got the ball inside the 10-yard line, Thorne zipping it down the field, and of course he went to the air to cap the drive.
Double wide receivers right and left, Cobb flanks Thorne. Second and one from the State 7-yard line. Thorne drops, looks, floats it, Cobb. Touchdown! Jeremiah Cobb, a 7-yard strike from Thorne, who threw it perfectly. Touchdown, Auburn!
8-play, 68-yard drive, and the Tigers used up a minute 6, left only 9 seconds on the clock as they took a 24-3 lead. And that's your score at halftime, 24-3. Auburn with a great offensive performance, over 300 yards in the first half, as Peyton Thorne passed for 192. We'll give you all the stats when the Truck Works Halftime Report continues in a moment.
Andy Burcham here to tell you about our friends over at TruckWorks, the official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. TruckWorks is Alabama's exclusive Kenworth, Hino, and Isuzu commercial truck dealer, and the Southeast headquarters for dump trucks, sleeper trucks, box vans, and everything in between. Step into their TRP parts store in Opelika for all your commercial truck, trailer, and bus parts needs. TruckWorks, the partner you can count on in the transportation industry since 1978.
In football, it's important to call the right play. In life, it can be even more important to make the right call, especially regarding termite protection. To protect my home, I called Cook's Pest Control and got the Centricon system. You don't have to live with termites. For a free quote, make the right call. Cook's Pest Control and the Centricon system.
Looky, 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 here comes Cookie, Cook's Pest Control.
When you live in SEC country, you feel it everywhere you go. The traditions and rivalries surround you.
As much as you celebrate the game, Regions celebrates your financial wins even more. And like SEC fans, we'll never quit. Because in an SEC world, we're the SEC Bank. Regions, official bank of the SEC, member FDIC.
Tackle your to-do list this season and find the right Aetna Medicare plan for you in your home state of Alabama. With Aetna Medicare Advantage plans, you can get a $0 monthly plan premium with hospital, medical, and prescription drug coverage. Plans also include dental, vision, and an over-the-counter benefit. Be the star quarterback of your health. Call us for a personalized coverage review now. 1-833-771-7542. TTY-711. Aetna Medicare is an HMO PPO plan with a Medicare contract. RSNPs also have contracts with state Medicaid programs. Enrollment in our plans depends on contract renewal. Plan features and availability may vary by service area.
This copyrighted broadcast is authorized under rights granted to Play Fly Sports by Auburn University and is intended solely for the entertainment of our audience. It may not be rebroadcast or retransmitted in any form without the documented consent of Auburn University and Play Fly Sports.
Auburn came out, played fast, put the ball in the air, and dominated the first half, leading 24-3. Time now for your first half statistics presented by the Alabama Department of Public Health. They remind you, don't wait, vaccinate. Protect yourself and others by staying current on all recommended vaccines, including COVID and flu. Visit alabamapublichealth.gov/IMM. First downs, Auburn with 15, Mississippi State with 6. State had 76 yards on the ground, 46 yards in the air. They snapped it 29 times for 122 yards. Auburn, 109 yards on the ground, 192 yards in the air. Auburn, 36 plays, 301 yards, about 9 yards per snap for the Tigers. On third down, there were no turnovers, by the way. Third down, Mississippi State was 0 for 6, Auburn 2 for 3. State was 1-for-2 on fourth down. Auburn did not attempt a fourth down attempt. Penalties, State was penalized 3 times for 20 yards. Auburn 4 times for 35 yards. Individually, Mike Wright, the Mississippi State quarterback, had 26 yards rushing the ball. And Seth Davis, the backup tailback, with 20 net yards on 4 attempts. For Auburn, Jarquez Hunter, 10 carries, 73 yards. Peyton Thorne ran it 3 times for 23 yards, both averaged over 7 yards per carry. In the air, Mike Wright, 4-for-10 for 46 yards, a long of 32, and that came on their first offensive snap. Peyton Thorne was 15-for-20, 192, 3 touchdowns. Neither quarterback suffered a sack. Receiver Xavion Thomas caught 3 for State for 42 yards. Rivaldo Fairweather had 3 catches for 22. Javarius Johnson, 2 catches for 59 yards and a touchdown. Shane Hooks had 1 for 27 yards and a touchdown as well. Jet Johnson led State in tackles with 6. Nathaniel Watson had 5. For Auburn, Eugene Asante had 5, as did Keontae Scott. That's your halftime statistics. And a look at the halftime as Auburn dominated throughout, and the Tigers lead it 24-3. Mississippi State will have the ball coming out for the second half. The Auburn band has finished their show. Specialists are out on the field on a perfect day for football. We're getting set for second half action. Remember, Truck Works is the official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers, and this is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promises.
Do you say War Eagle instead of hello? See tigers in the clouds? Never wear crimson and white together? If so, there's no better way to show your tiger pride than with the Auburn University Regions Visa debit card and prepaid Regions Now card. As passionate as you are about Auburn, Regions is even more passionate about celebrating your every financial win and helping you plan for the next one. To order your card, visit regions.com/go tigers.
Regions, official bank of the SEC, member FDIC. Terms, conditions, and fees apply.
Kia of Auburn is happy to connect the Kia brand to the Auburn fans. Our winning lineup has something for everyone at almost any budget. SUVs like the Telluride, Sorento, and Sportage. You prefer a sedan? Check out the Rio, Forte, Soul, or the Sporty Stinger. And don't forget our new multi-purpose vehicles, the Carnival, or our amazing hybrid or electric vehicles. Kia of Auburn is a proud supporter of Auburn Athletics. Kia of Auburn, where you're always number one. Bold, Rico.
At Oslo USA, we're building ships that protect and defend our nation. Building innovative ships requires innovative people. We're looking for Tiger fans to join the build. We offer 4 10-hour day work schedules for our production employees, comprehensive benefits, and individualized training programs that make our dynamic workforce even stronger. Visit OsloJobs.com to apply today and build a strong future. Oslo USA, innovative on land, exceptional at sea.
Halftime at Jordan-Hare Stadium, Auburn 24, Mississippi State 3. State will have the ball to open the second half. Take it to the house with the Alabama Manufactured Housing Association and the Auburn Tigers. This week's Take It to the House contestant is Wanda McCurdy from Opelika. If Auburn returns his first received kickoff for the second half for a touchdown, Wanda wins up to $75,000 towards the purchase of a manufactured home from an authorized AMHA dealer. If the Tigers score a touchdown within the first three plays of the drive, Wanda wins $25,000. Register for your chance to win at auburntigers.com/take-it-to-the-house. Well, Peyton Thorne in the first half was terrific for Auburn. Jason, 15 of 20, 192 yards, 3 touchdowns. He threw to 11 different receivers in the first half. What was the difference in that first half for Auburn offensively than what we have seen really in the last month of this season?
Yeah, very efficient that first half by Peyton Thorne. But what we saw differently is we got back to running our tempo offense. We haven't seen much of it since the UMass game. We hit a couple games there in a row where we was kind of a little inept offensively. Couldn't get into rhythm, couldn't get things going. And today, I think Coach Freeze, Coach Montgomery said pregame that, hey, they was going to calm some things down, take out a lot of thinking for our guys, and let them just kind of go out and play and take out the complexity of the offense. So I think that worked really well for Auburn today. The guys seem to be playing with a different speed, a different tempo. Everyone seems to know exactly what to do and be exactly where they're supposed to be. And getting our receivers involved in this game early on, I thought, was the key. Throwing those short hitch routes, those slant routes, those quick outs, that gets you into a rhythm and a flow. It may not look like a lot or explosive plays, but those are things that get your team ready to go.
As well as Auburn played offensively, I thought it was as good a half as Auburn has had from a wide receiver standpoint, certainly from a quarterback standpoint. A little bit of love for that Auburn offensive line with the true freshman Connor Lew at center.
Yeah, Connor Lew has done an outstanding job at the offensive line today. You know, this is his first start. 17-year-old, we talked about coming in and starting this game. But I think he's gotten a lot of help, though, Andy, with Cam Stutz and Gunnar Britt playing right guard and left guard on side of him. So when he has to go run block, those guys are helping him get a push before getting up to the second level to block those linebackers. So I think he's done an outstanding job. We haven't had any false starts for real. We had two by Dylan Wade, but it wasn't anticipated by the center, which you would think sometimes you would have with a young guy.
As well as Auburn played defensively in the first half, you do have to temper it just a bit. State is playing without its starting quarterback and without its starting tailback, and yet Auburn is playing a very good game from a defensive standpoint.
Yeah, State came out and you knew missing their running back Marks and then missing their starting quarterback Will Rogers. They came out trying to be aggressive. They took 2 shots early in this game. They hit the first pass. They've had some guys a little bit, but they hadn't been able to get on the same page. They had a couple miscues, 2 people in the same area, 1-time guy blocking downfield, not expecting the pass. So they've had some things offensively that's going against them. But our defense is one of the best defenses in the SEC, and we've done a really good job of stopping them, especially in that fourth down, four half.
All right, that's one half of football. You've got another half of football left. Let's remember where we were 2 years ago against Mississippi State. Now, granted, it was Will Rogers running the show, And State came back and won that. But, boy, I mean, you need another half of football like we saw in the first half today.
Yeah, you can't get complacent, Andy, coming in the second half. You know, 28-3 is not safe in college or pros. You know, a lot of people know that. But, you know, you got to come out and still be aggressive here in this second half. And the defense gets a chance to set the tempo this time. The offense did the first time.
Tulu Griffin back at the one as McPherson puts his right foot into it. And Griffin will return this one from the six. out to the 15, moves forward to Luke Griffin into the clear and gets near the 30-yard line. An incredibly dangerous offensive threat for Mississippi State, the senior Tulu Griffin out of Philadelphia, Mississippi.
Tulu Griffin right there, I tell you, man, we was one shoe screen tackle away right there from probably getting open in midfield.
And you know who it was? It was Jarquez Hunter.
Oh, Jarquez.
Two Philadelphia, Mississippi guys going there.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure they know each other pretty well, but Jarquez doesn't make that tackle right there. We got to hope that McPherson doesn't have to hurt, have to try to stop open field tackle with Tulu. It's not a good place to be.
First down for State. Mike Wright, the quarterback in the pistol with Jeffrey Pittman, who takes the carry, and Pittman gets banged. He gets across the 30, out to the 31, and a flag is down, and we may get a face mask on Auburn. Eugene Asante at the bottom of that pile for the Tigers.
Personal foul. Blindside by offense number 3. The penalty will be enforced from the previous spot, half the distance to the goal. First down.
That was Justin Robinson, the wide receiver, a redshirt junior from McDonough, Georgia, transferred from Georgia, called for that blindside block. I'll be honest, when the tackle was made, I was hoping that we weren't going to see some kind of targeting. It was a violent hit by Eugene Asante.
Yeah, right there, Richardson making that blindside block right there on Zion Puckett. Back in the day, Andy, I'm going to be honest with you, I'm a football player. That's what you used to teach your receivers to do, is go block the safety. There wasn't much to that block right there for the 15-yard penalty, but we'll take it.
Trips to the right side for State. A single receiver wide left, that's Freddie Robertson. Handoff to the tailback. He fights his way out to the 20. And a flag goes down. We're going to get another illegal block, I think this time on Freddie Robertson.
Yeah, definitely gonna get a hold right there, holding Nehemiah Pritchett right there by, Nehemiah Pritchett trying to get around right there, getting grabbed.
That would be an illegal block.
That would be an illegal block. Yeah. Now I'm a football player again, Andy.
Yes, and you are. There's no question.
Number 19, 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul, remains first down.
State has run two plays. They've been called for a crackback block, an illegal block, and a hold. And State now backed up to the 10-yard line.
Yeah, not where you want to be at coming out of halftime, going backwards off two huge penalties right now, putting you in a first and almost a 30 situation.
First and 27, Seth Davis flanks right, ball at the left hash at the 10. Harmon goes in motion, sets up as the tight end. Wright drops, now he's going to run it, and Wright gets out to the 17-yard line before Eugene Asante brings him down.
Eugene Asante in on a lot of tackles today. Seemed like we called his name a lot and Keontae Scott name a lot today on that defense.
Six tackles now for Eugene Asante for the Tigers. He is the Auburn game leader at this point. And it brings up a long situation for Mississippi State. 20. Second and 20. Right to throw. He gets pressure. He's in trouble. He throws it, and we're going to get a flag thrown upfield. Yeah, the pressure came from DJ James.
Yeah, they're going to get Marcus Harris pulling down the running back on the holding call there.
And had that not been thrown, I think that would have been grounding on State.
Yeah, because
he wasn't out of the tackle box.
It was going to be a screen play.
Holding. Defense, number 50. The 10-yard penalty will be enforced from the previous spot, and it will include an automatic first down.
Oh, my goodness. That just takes you out of the hole.
Yeah, that's just like last week, Andy. It was a third and 17 against Ole Miss, and we ended up getting a pass interference call that gave Ole Miss a first down. This one's right there with it. You get a holding call in a situation like that where Mississippi State is probably not going to dig themselves out of this, and right there we just gave them a first down with a holding.
First down out to the 27 for State. Ball in the middle of the field. Right from the gun. Play action. Right pressured. Looks and he throws. It is caught but out of bounds at the 42-yard line. Number 3, Justin Robinson.
Yeah, right there they're trying to run a deep 7 route, what we call a corner ball right there. Richardson just flattened that route out right there at the top of it. I mean, Robinson was trying to flatten that route out and get the ball from Mike Wright, but right there, not enough space on that sideline to complete that pass.
Second and 10 from the 27 for State. Robinson splits wide to the right. That's the State boundary. Pittman, the tailback. Right hands it inside handoff, jet sweep left side down the sideline. Xavier Thomas out of bounds, and that's a first down, I believe, for Mississippi State.
Yeah, quick action right there by Mississippi State, getting Xavier Thomas lined up in that, almost in the backfield. Right there, getting that sweet play on the outside edge. Play action by Mike Wright to the right, kind of took the defense, eyes with him, allowing that backside run by Xavier right there for a first down for Mississippi State.
At the 39-yard line for State. Opening drive of the third quarter, Auburn leads State 24-3. Right from the gun, out of the pistol, as a matter of fact. Wright turns, hands the ball to the tailback, and Pittman gets 5 yards out to the 45-yard line before Keontae Scott, the junior from San Diego, comes up to make the stop for Auburn. Nice, a 6-yard gain. Second and 4 for State at the 45.
Yeah, Keontae Scott right there coming to make that tackle. Zacchavius Walker right now checking in for Keldrick Falk at that left end position.
Ball between the hashes, double wide receivers right, make that double receivers to the left, a trips to the wide side of the field, an empty backfield for Wright. Drops to throw, looks to the Auburn boundary, now looks to the other way. Being pressured, steps into the throw, up the field, and it's incomplete. Intended for Justin Robinson. Larry, that was Larry Nixon III with coverage on the play.
Yeah, Larry Nixon getting deep down the field right there. Mike Wright wanted something to his left, couldn't find it, scramble a little bit to his right. Saw his big man Robinson running down the middle right there. Gonna try to take a shot. That ball looked to come out of his hand a little funky right there, Andy.
Yeah, he had some pressure. Third and 4 for State from the 45-yard line. In the first half, State was 0 of 6 on third down. Auburn rushes 6. Hand off, tailback. Lots of room right up the gut. He's to the 35, makes a move to the Auburn 20 and down to the 18-yard line before Nehemiah Pritchett brings down number 23, Seth Davis.
Man, that hole opened up wide right there for Seth Davis. Mississippi State offensive line doing a great job of creating some confusion right there for Auburn defensive line. A gain of 37 right there on that run for Seth Davis.
A career high 86 yards rushing for Davis in the win over Western Michigan. Had 10 carries that day. First down for State at the Auburn 18-yard line. Right, Davis, Davis taken down by Larry Nixon III with some help from Cam Riley, but Nixon was the first one there.
Yeah, Larry Nixon known for his tackling ability right there. Heads up play to get Seth Davis on the ground right there. Mississippi Auburn defense known as the number one red zone defense in the SEC right now. Doing a really good job of holding their opponents in this part of the field. We're going to need another stand right here to hold this Mississippi State offense to 3.
Auburn holding SEC opponents to in the red zone to just 78% scoring. Third in the SEC in turnover margin as well. Second and 8 from the 16 for State. Right to his right, now his left, and Wright tripped up at the 15-yard line. Nehemiah Pritchett was there for the Tigers. Wesley Steiner was there for Auburn as well.
Yeah, they try to run a fake toss to the right there. Mike Wright trying to keep it backside on that left side. Trying to catch Auburn defense. Not paying attention backside. Good job of staying home right there. Create a third and 4 situation for the Auburn defense here.
Third down from the 14 for State. Robinson split wide right. They stack receivers just off the left tackle on the left side. Right from the gun. It's a reverse, trying to get to the outside, Thomas. He's not gonna get there. Back at the 22. There were a host of Auburn jerseys there, including number 13, Cam Riley, and number 91, Zacchavius Walker.
Yeah, great job by the Auburn defense right there. A staying home backside, creating a negative 9 game for Mississippi State. Creating a negative play is huge. That's why they're the number one team in the SEC in red zone defense. It tells you right there, everyone sticks to their assignments and doing your own job.
This will be a 31-yard field goal attempt. Ball in the middle of the field from Kyle Free out of Woodstock, Georgia. Left-footed kicker. Kick down, kick on the way. Kick is good. The only 2 scores today for State are field goals by Faree. 9:10 to go in the third quarter. Auburn about to get the ball for the first time in the second half when we return. Auburn 24, Mississippi State 6. And Auburn football continues in a moment.
For generations, Alabama Extension has played a vital role in bettering the world around us. And by taking information discovered through Auburn University research to the people, we are empowering communities to tackle the challenges of tomorrow in a rapidly changing world. As educators, Extension is a partner in every county, bringing practical ways to better our homes, farms, people, and overall way of life. Alabama Extension, extending knowledge, improving lives. Discover more by visiting aces.edu.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical?
You always say Vibrantly Tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
Some days I cover up because of my moderate to severe plaque psoriasis. Now I'm hitting the road with clearer skin thanks to Skyrizi, Risankizumab Riza, a prescription-only 150 milligram injection for adults who are candidates for systemic or phototherapy. With Skyrizi, 3 out of 4 people achieved 90% clearer skin at 4 months. And Skyrizi is just 4 doses a year after 2 starter doses.
Don't use if allergic to Skyrizi. Serious allergic reactions and an increased risk of infections or a lower ability to fight them may occur. Before treatment, your doctor should check for infection and tuberculosis. Tell your doctor if you have an infection or symptoms, such as fever, sweats, chills, muscle aches, or cough, or if you plan to or recently received a vaccine.
Thanks to Skyrizi, there's nothing on my skin, and that means everything. Ask your doctor today about Skyrizi, the number one dermatologist prescribed biologic in psoriasis. And visit skyrizi.com or call 1-866-SKYRIZI to learn more.
State went 50 yards in 12 plays, 5 minutes and 45 seconds on the opening drive of the third quarter. Fries gave him a 40-yard field goal. Makes it a 24-6 Auburn lead. Tigers about to get the ball for the first time in the second half. Auburn's offense in the first half as good as we've seen it all season for that first 2 quarters of play. And you want to see Auburn continue the execution, Jason, here in the second half of play.
Yeah, most definitely want to see Auburn offense continue to play with the energy, continue to play with that high tempo offense. Keep the offense, keep these guys flowing, keep the receivers involved in the game, continue to run the ball with Jarquez and Damari and those guys, mixing it up really well, causing confusion for the Mississippi State defense. Mississippi State expected us to come out and run the ball a lot in the first half. We kind of did the opposite. We caught them in a lot of man coverage and able to hit those explosive plays that we talked about that Auburn would need in this game to come out with a victory.
Nick Barmira is the kickoff specialist for State. Brian Batee back at the Auburn goal line. Sean Jackson at about the 3. 24-6 Auburn, 9:10 to go in the third. Kickoff in the air, and Batee will watch it sail about 8 yards deep into the end zone. In the first half of play, Peyton Thorne was 15 of 20 for 192 yards and 3 touchdowns. He threw to 11 different receivers. Rivaldo Fairweather led Auburn with 3 catches. The leading man yardage-wise was Javarius Johnson with 59 yards. First and 10 at the 25, ball in the middle of the field for the Tigers.
See if Mississippi State does anything differently here, Andy. See if they get out of the 4-down and go back to their 3-down defense. And since we've been passing the ball pretty good, see if they can try to stop our passing game.
Jarquez Hunter, 10 carries for 73 yards in the backfield. A movement up front for Auburn. We'll get the call from Daniel Gotro.
False start. Offense, number 62. 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
Cam Stutz.
That's twice, Andy. We've jumped offensively when the defense stems. We have to expect that and hold your water a little better.
First and 15, Fairweather in motion. It's Thorne on the keeper. Thorne around left side. Thorne out near the 35, near the first down marker. Going to be about a yard shy.
Yeah, another great call by Coach Montgomery right there. Another drive starter for Thorne, picking up first down. I mean, picking up good yardage.
Second and 1. Jarquez Hunter has the first down head down across the 35-yard line. They give him the 38. Falling or going behind Connor Luke, Cam Stutz, and Gunnar Britton. the interior three of that offensive front. Auburn right back to the line of scrimmage. Auburn hustles Malcolm Johnson Jr. into the ball game, replacing Caleb Burton. First down for the Tigers at the 38-yard line. Hunter goes in motion out of the backfield to the state boundary. Thorne from the gun. State rushes four. Pump fake, throws, pass complete. Rivaldo Fairweather, 9 yards for the Tigers.
Yeah, good job of Thorne right there, kind of using some baseball technique right there, getting the Mississippi State defender to jump in the air and to kind of side on that ball around him right there to Fairweather for a nice pickup.
Second and one again for the Tigers. Right back to the line of scrimmage. Hunter, Jarquez taken down in the backfield. There was no chance for Jarquez. Nathaniel Watson was up in his grill, and it's a loss back to the 44-yard line.
Yeah, Nathaniel Watson, one of those guys that averaged 10.1 tackles per game in the SEC. They haven't had many opportunities today. Our offensive line has done a pretty good job of neutralizing Mississippi State's defensive front, running the football, and even in pass protection, they've done an outstanding job of giving Thorne time.
Watson, a week ago, 14 tackles, 2 sacks in that win at Arkansas, the SEC co-defensive player of the week. Third and four for Auburn. The Tigers on third down in the first half, 2 of 5. Just inside the left hash mark. Send Jarquez out of the backfield. They flip it to Jarquez. Got to make the first man miss, and he gets forward out to the 49-yard line. Near midfield, that's an Auburn first down.
Yeah, I like the design right there. Put Jarquez on one side, see what the defense is doing, see if they're in man in the zone, and bring him back in a little quick motion before you snap the ball. You catch him in man. Great blocking right there by the outside receiver, getting Jarquez a chance to turn up field and get that first down.
Batte now the tailback for the Tigers. Flanks Thorne to his left. Ball will be snapped from the right hash. Fair in motion. Thorne to Brian Batte to the Auburn boundary. And he's hit at the line of scrimmage and loses a yard in the play. Nothing doing that time for Brian Batte.
Yeah, Auburn.
John Lewis with the stop. Excuse me. Nah,
great job by Lewis right there. He kept contained right there, not letting Brian Batte get outside, which is that's his job. Good job. Just a good play right there by Mississippi State's defense.
A loss of 1 second and 11 for Auburn at its own 48-yard line. From the hash. State moves up front. Fromm goes in motion. Handoff to the tailback. Batte fights his way to the line of scrimmage, and that is all. Not a lot doing to the short side of the field, and Batte is slow to get up. Or is that a lineman?
Yeah, too tall, Miller.
Ooh, and he's holding his head, holding the helmet a little bit. Yeah, they're going to stop play to get Too Tall Miller some help. And Jaden Muskrat will come in for the Tigers.
Yeah, Too Tall was laying there. He tried to get up and walk a little bit. You kind of saw his legs get a little weak right there.
You can see him hold his helmet and then went down to a knee. SeatGeek now the official ticketing partner of Auburn Athletics. Whether you're buying or selling football tickets, SeatGeek is the place to do it. SeatGeek. So Tiger fans can fan. We'll give you an update on Too Tall Miller when we come back. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Hey, Tiger fans, be sure to join Coach Jay and Auburn Women's Basketball this season in Neville Arena. Limited reserve seating options for season tickets are on sale now. The package includes home games against Tennessee, LSU, Alabama, and South Carolina. For more information or to purchase season tickets, visit auvtix.com. Thank you for supporting Auburn Women's Basketball, and see you this season in Neville Arena. War Eagle!
The sweet smell of victory and grilled burgers still hang in the air. Your tailgate was a big win thanks to your Ford F-150 truck. With available Pro Power onboard, you used your F-150 as a mobile generator. That kept the celebration going long after the final whistle. See your local Ford dealer for great offers on a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. See owner's manual for important operating instructions.
Bertram here to tell you about our friends over at Truckworks, the official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Truckworks is Alabama's exclusive Kenworth, Hino, and Isuzu commercial truck dealer, and the Southeast headquarters for dump trucks, sleeper trucks, box vans, and everything in between. Step into their TRP parts store in Opelika for all your commercial truck, trailer, and bus parts needs. Truckworks, the partner you can count on in the transportation industry since 1978.
When the game goes into overtime,
but the game goes into overtime. The choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Xavier Miller was able to walk off the field. Jaden Muskrat has checked in at right tackle, 6'3", 302, junior from Berry Hill, Oklahoma. As Auburn looks at third and 10 from its own 49-yard line. Trips to the wide side of the field. That's the state boundary. Damari Alston is the tailback for the Tigers. The lone man split to the Auburn boundary is Hollywood Hooks. Third and 10 for Auburn. Tigers need the state 41-yard line for a first down. The snap to Thorne with some time. Throws, pass, complete. Jay Fair has it at the 39, and Fair is slow to get up now.
Yeah, I'll give Thorne a lot of credit on that. We hung in there knowing he's about to take a direct hit. Jay Fair coming friendly back to the ball right there, make a completion for a first down for Auburn. Hope
Fair,
he's okay.
Fair sitting down right now on the turf and the medical staff for Auburn. And now Fair gets up and jogs off the field just as Mike Goodluck got there.
Yeah, it might be one of those, Andy, where you get hit and wind gets knocked out of you for a little bit and just take a little bit of time to catch your breath enough to get up and run off the field.
14 yards and a first down for Auburn. First down for the Tigers at the state 37-yard line. Auburn leads Mississippi State 24-6.
Yeah, big completion right there. I was glad to see, you know, Peyton Thorne keep his eyes downfield, not get focused on the rush, and deliver a good football right there to Jay Fair.
Damari Alston, the carry. Damari Alston hit at the line of scrimmage and goes down as we send it downstairs. Cook's Pest Control sideline report with Ronnie Brown.
All right, guys, when Too Tall came to the sideline, they were looking more at the jaw area. They didn't take his hat, so that's usually a sign that it wasn't anything head-related. So I'll get an update on that. But he seems to be okay. He has his helmet on the top of his head, so I'll check it out and give you guys a follow-up.
All right, Ronnie, thank you. Second and 10 from the 37. Thorne rolls to the Auburn boundary. Looking downfield, Thorne will run it. He goes out of bounds at the 35-yard line. Gets a couple yards in the play. It's going to bring up third down and 8.
Yeah, Auburn trying to hit that rollout pass. They've hit Jarquez Hunter on twice today for a good amount of games right there. Try to do the same with Damari Alston right there. State played them pretty well. Thorne did a good job of just getting out of bounds right there, not making a bad play worse.
Three receivers to the wide side of the field. That's the state boundary on third and 8. Now the tight end Fromm comes in motion to the Auburn boundary. State with 4 on the line of scrimmage. They threaten to blitz. Thorne looks to the sideline. Play clock is down to 6. Got a hustle. Play clock is down to 3. There's the snap. They bring the blitz. Thorne with some time. Floats it out. Damari Alston. Alston just runs over a man. Gets down to the 32-yard line. But he'll be shy of the first down.
Yeah, a little bit of chess match going on right there between Auburn offense and Mississippi State's defensive coordinator right there. Auburn saw something with the blitz and immediately decided to check the play. Then he saw Mississippi State make an adjustment as well. End up forcing a fourth down and field goal here by McPherson.
It's a 50 or 49-yard field goal attempt by Alex McPherson. His longest is a 53-yarder this season. The holder is Oscar Chapman. Snap down. Kick on the way. Plenty of leg. And this one is plenty good. Whoo! Well, that had plenty of distance on it, didn't it?
Yeah, Oscar Chapman, you know, this guy known for his kicking ability coming out of high school. And right there, he just nailed one. He's been 12 or 13 so far this year. What a big kick right there by Alex McPherson. Not a huge guy, 5'9", 150, but got a huge leg.
14th straight made field goal for McPherson. 3:14 to go in the third quarter. Auburn 27, Mississippi State 6. Auburn football continues in a moment.
What does commitment sound like? At Alabama Power, we hear you, we see you, and celebrate you on long practice days, game days that bring us together, and every day in between. Your commitment to making an impact for the team, for the fans, that inspires us to be at our best for the communities we champion across the state. We're committed to this kind of energy. That's power for a better Alabama. Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Hey y'all, this is Ronte, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the pimento cheese. I was like, go cheese, go pimento, go honey, go get it.
Hi, this is Chantrese, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich is the mild spiciness of the pickled jalapenos. No, it's the crispy chicken. Actually, I can't decide. It's the entire sandwich.
Order the honey pepper pimento chicken sandwich on the Chick-fil-A app today. Available for a limited time. Real Chick-fil-A guests paid for their testimonials.
Are you looking to advance your career without putting your life on hold? Consider the flexibility of an online MBA at Auburn University's Harvard College of Business. Ranked among the nation's best by U.S. News & World Report, our 100% online MBA program provides the flexibility you need to pursue a degree while maintaining your personal and professional life. Learn more at harvard.auburn.edu.
Hey Auburn fans, it's Coach Freeze. Few plays are more exciting than the sack. For every Auburn sack this season, a donation is made to help the Ascension St. Vincent's Foundation invest in PE equipment for schools around the state. Cultivating a healthy lifestyle early helps prevent chronic diseases. Please join Jill and me by making a donation to SAC Childhood Obesity. Visit stvhsfoundation.org, War Eagle.
Today's game is brought to you by Alabama Extension, where extending knowledge means improving lives for everyone in Alabama. Visit aces.edu to learn more. Now, back to Jordan-Hare Stadium.
Thank you, Mark Aston. Sun South John Deere Drive summary. Auburn goes 44 yards, 12 plays, 556. McPherson's 49-yard field goal. Sun South John Deere, preferred tractor of the Tigers. Find your local dealer at sunsouth.com. 3:14 to go in the third quarter. Tigers on top 27-6. Peyton Thorne, 19 of 24, 224 yards, three touchdowns. Jarquez Hunter, 12 carries, 74 yards, leading the Tigers today from an offensive standpoint. McPherson booms it. Tulu Griffin will let it sail into the end zone. Let's get a scoreboard update. Here's Paul Ellen.
All right, top 25 action, 26 unanswered by number one Georgia. They lead Florida 26-7 early in the third. Texas 21-3 over BYU as they play middle of the third. Bo Nix having a day. Eighth-ranked Oregon beating Utah in Salt Lake 35-6. They are playing in the middle of the third as well. And Notre Dame rolling over Pittsburgh in South Bend 37-0. That's middle of the third as well, Andy.
All right, Paul, thank you very much. First and 10, Mississippi State at its own 25 left hash mark. The tailback is Jeffrey Pittman, 27 yards rushing on the day. Tulu Griffin goes in motion, right play action, now looks back to the Auburn boundary, throws up the boundary, pass is complete for a first down to Xavier Thomas.
Yeah, that was a good throw right there by Mike Wright, hanging in the pocket, hitting that deep crosser route right there.
Jalen Simpson on the coverage, but not before State gets to its own 44-yard line. Low snap, movement up front.
It had to be a false start, right?
I would think.
False start. Offense, number 64. 5-yard penalty, remains first down.
Steve Lasoya, the third, transferred from Middle Tennessee. He's making his 31st start today. Cameron Jones making his 39th start. That's consecutive start at right tackle. 35th start for the center, Cole Smith. 20th start for the left guard, Nick Jones. 22nd start for Quatrivius Thomas, or Johnson, the left tackle. Handoff, right side. Nothing doing out there for Jeffrey Pittman. Terrific pursuit by Auburn. Eugene Asante was the first one there. He got some help from Austin Keys on the play, and Jason Jones.
Yeah, Austin Keys, another one of those guys from Taylorsville, Mississippi. Coming up, making a tackle right there against one of his former in-state rivals.
You're having fun with the Taylorsville, Mississippi today, aren't you?
I'm going to say some Mississippi guys today, you know. Taylorsville got two of them on the field.
Second and 15 for State. Right side tailback. Across the 50s, hurdles a man across midfield. Nice carry out there by Jeffrey Pittman, a junior from
Taylorsville, Mississippi.
Yep, into Auburn territory, down to the Tiger 40-yard line. Make that the 39.
I can't remember the last time I've seen two Taylorsville guys on the field at the same time. It's besides myself and Tim Duxworth.
I was going to say, there had to be some in your
yeah,
day.
Yeah, back in the day a little bit, but you know, today we got two out there right now. Austin Keys is a big part of this Auburn defense, though, being able to come back last week against Ole Miss.
1:28 to go in the third quarter, 27-6 Auburn. Stayed on the move at the Auburn 39. Wright looks and he throws. The pass is complete to Pittman, and Pittman is corralled down that right sideline by Eugene Asante.
Eugene Asante seems to be like a magnet to the football. It doesn't matter where the ball is at on the field. He always finds a way to have a hand on the ball or on somebody that's close within vicinity of that ball.
8 tackles, 6 solos today for Eugene Asante. That's a 2-yard gain. Second down at the Auburn 38 for State. Ball at the right hash. Simeon Price checks in at tailback for State, number 22. Flanks right to his left. Wright's going to run it around left end. Wright 35 inside the 30 and down to the 28-yard line. Wesley Steiner riding the back of the Mississippi State quarterback, Mike Wright.
Yeah, State has done a really good job today of those design quarterback runs, again, that big offensive line, which you said all of them have over 20 starts, getting them out in front of him, creating some running room for him to pick up the first down right there.
11 yards to the Auburn 27-yard line for Wright from the left hash. Low snap around the left side to the 20. He's down to the 15 before he goes out of bounds. Another 10-yard gain for Mike Wright.
And that should take us to the fourth quarter right there, Andy.
Final seconds tick away in quarter number 3. Nothing but field goals in the third. Auburn 27, Mississippi State 6. Auburn University isn't just home to the best athletics program in the nation. It's also home to the best student-centered engineering experience in America. And that's not just a slogan, it's a promise. Find your future at the Samuel Ginn College of Engineering. Visit eng.auburn.edu. Fourth quarter on the way. Stay tuned. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Life isn't made for joint or orthopedic pain. It's made for living, for family, for your favorite hobbies, for sports, for morning walks and afternoon playing in the park. If you suffer from joint or orthopedic pain, turn to the experts at the Orthopedic Clinic. Our board-certified surgeons provide cutting-edge surgical procedures and high-quality, innovative services all close to home. Don't let joint or orthopedic pain keep you from doing all the things you love. Visit theorthoclinic.com and schedule an appointment today.
Earn more on your balances with the Max Elevate Money Market. Enjoy the competitive rate benefits of certificate accounts with no fixed terms and more flexibility. Earn more on your balances and access them anytime. You expect more, and Max delivers. See our amazing rates at mymax.com/elevate. Max, smart money made simple. Federally insured by NCUA. Certain restrictions apply.
You will love Buff City Soap. Their soap bars, oils, body butters, bath bombs, and laundry soaps are wonderful. Handmade and customized for you using plant-based ingredients that delight your skin and your nose. See partywithbuff.com and bring your kids or friends to make some magic. Buff City is also fantastic for gifts or fundraisers for your organization. Located in the 320 West Magnolia Building with the downtown Auburn Chick-fil-A and convenient parking. Buff City Soap, plant-based and handmade daily so you smell wonderful.
Fine Dining meets Southern Comfort at Vintage 2298, Auburn's newest fine dining restaurant and butcher shop. Chef Randall Baldwin and wife Laura present Gulf cuisine with a Southern flair made fresh farm to table. Seasonal meats, cheeses, wine, and handcrafted cocktails available next door at the butcher shop. Manager Stephen Jacobs and staff bring a new level of service to local dining at Vintage 2298. Private dining and event space available, as well as awesome tailgate packages found in the butcher shop. Experience Vintage 2298.
Well, the third quarter wound up a tie, 3-3, each team with a field goal. Mississippi State drove 50 yards in 12 plays for their field goal to open the second half. Auburn answered with a 44-yard drive in 12 plays. McPherson from 49 yards to equal State's drive, 27-6. Mississippi State with only their second possession of the second half. Auburn only had it one time in the third quarter, and State has driven into the Auburn red zone. 27-6, Auburn leads. State is now threatening. And this game recap sponsored by Wind Creek Casino and Hotel, with 3 Alabama locations in Atmore, Montgomery, and Wetumpka. You can escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and Hotel and at windcreekcasino.com. So we go to the fourth, State threatening on their second possession. Auburn's kept them out of the end zone so far. Fourth quarter action coming up with Auburn leading 27-6. Here's Andy Burcham.
All right, Paul, thank you very much. First and 10 for State at the Auburn 14 left hash mark. Creed Whitmore splits wide right. Justin Robinson in the slot. Wright drops to throw. Looks to the end zone. It's caught. A one-handed grab by Xavier Thomas, working on Keontae Scott for the touchdown.
Yeah, you couldn't play that ball any better by Keontae Scott. That's just a heck of a catch right there by Xavier Thomas. One-handed catch. He's had two on this drive, Andy. The one on the sideline on the deep over route and right there for the touchdown. Great ball placement right there by Mike Wright. Keontae Scott, right position. Just a better play by the offensive receiver right there.
Third touchdown pass of the year for Wright. First touchdown of the year for Xavier Thomas, and it was a dandy. And now Faria is out for the extra point for Mississippi State. First play in the fourth quarter. State finds the end zone, and Faria's extra point makes the score. With 14:54 to go in the fourth quarter, Auburn 27, Mississippi State 13. That's a good drive by Mississippi State. State goes seven plays, 75 yards, 3 minutes and 20 seconds. The touchdown pass from Mike Wright to Xavier Thomas, and a lot of that drive was Mike Wright, Jason, running the football and running it well.
Yeah, utilizing Mike Wright's legs. We talked about it, Andy. They want to come in the game plan. They've done a really good job with their design run package with him in the backfield of picking up positive yards and getting those first downs by utilizing his legs. But then also here in the second half, they want to try to hit some of those deep over routes, those one-on-one routes, and give his guys an opportunity with the ball by throwing it to them where only their guy can get it. So right now, this is still a ball game. It's 27-13.
Yes, it
we need our fans to hang in here. Don't leave too soon. We needed to get loud when Mississippi State is back on offense.
Two touchdown Auburn lead. Nick Bar-Mira will kick it away. Brian Batty about a foot into the end zone. And this will be returnable from the one. Batty fumbled the football. He picked it up, and he's tripped, and he gets out to the 15-yard line.
Yeah, we're fortunate right there. Batty coming up trying to catch that ball. Didn't get a chance to catch many over the last 2 weeks, but fortunate that ball didn't get too far in front of him right there. He was able to get grasp of it for him.
And Batty is hobbled as he comes to the sideline. He was slow to get up, and he comes off the boundary. First and 10 for Auburn at its own 15. Make that the 14-yard line. Auburn leads it 27-13. Just the start of things in the third quarter of play. Thorne, the quarterback, and Jarquez Hunter, the tailback. Thorne's under center for the first time today. Pitches the ball, Jarquez Hunter, and Jarquez is tripped as he gets across the 15-yard line. Stop made by Deontay Anderson, sophomore from Miami.
Yeah, Thorne lined up under center, haven't seen much of that. This season with the quarterback being underneath the center right there, able to get that ball out to Jarquez. Man, he was a shoestring tackle away from springing that for even a bigger gain.
A gain of three on the play, second and seven for the Tigers at the 17-yard line. Thorne turns, hands the ball to Jarquez Hunter. He has stood up at the line of scrimmage and loses a yard on the play. And State starting to seize the momentum right now. Again, Deontay Anderson on the stop, and this is third down for Auburn. Third and seven as the clock moves down to the 14-minute mark, and yep. Auburn leading 27-13. Thorne from the gun. From the left hash mark. Play clock at 13. As Jarquez Hunter now flanks Thorne to the left. State rushes six. Thorne gets rid of it. Caught shy of the first down to Camden Brown. Number four taken down by number four, DeCarlos Nicholson, on the stop against Camden Brown.
Yeah, it's going to be fourth and short here. I think Camden ran his route to the sticks to try to make sure he got the first, but I think he had to come back right there to catch that football, which kind of put him a yard behind on completing his first down right here.
Auburn goes three and out after State's first touchdown of the day.
Yeah, why it's important that everyone sit in their seats, because there's still a lot of ball game left.
Xavier Thomas to take this punt from Oscar Chapman, who booms it away. Fair catch called for by Thomas at the 32-yard line for Mississippi State. Clock stop with 13:01 to go in the fourth. Auburn leads Mississippi State 27-13 after a 45-yard boot by Oscar Chapman. Stay tuned, friends. Auburn football continues in a moment.
Recruiting plays a major role in team building. Recruiting also plays an important role in protecting my home from termites with Cook's Pest Control and the Centricon system. Termites eat the bait in the Centricon stations, then eagerly recruit other termites to also feed on the bait, thus eliminating the termite colony. You don't have to live with termites. Call Cook's Pest Control for a free quote.
Lookie, 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 here comes Cookie, Cook's Pest Control.
It's game day. What do you take to the tailgate? A flat screen TV? Take it to the tailgate. Your wife's favorite blender? A DJ sound system? With a Ford F-150 truck, you can take it all. With available Pro Power onboard that acts like a mobile generator, you can use F-150 to take your tailgate to the next level. Visit your local Ford dealer today. The Auburn Tigers and Ford F-150. Greatness starts here. See owner's manual for important operating instructions.
It takes hard work to be the best in the game. Planning, commitment, resilience, sweat. That's why Old Dominion Freight Line, the number one national LTL carrier for quality, works hard to be the best in the game and is proud to support those striving to be the best in theirs. Old Dominion Freight Line, official freight carrier of Auburn Athletics, helping the world keep promising.
The Houston Clinic would like to welcome Dr. Brad Young, the newest addition to our team of experienced medical professionals at Auburn's Houston Clinic. Specializing in joint replacements, sports medicine, and arthroscopic surgery, Dr. Young has treated athletes and worked with sports teams from middle and high school to college and professional teams. Call now to schedule your evaluation. Houston Clinic. Research, education, treatment. Houston.com.
.13:01 to go in the fourth quarter. Auburn leads Mississippi State 27-13. State ball from its own 33 when play resumes. As we pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Auburn Sports Network. It's a two-score game right now, friends. Auburn goes three and out after State's touchdown drive. Did State find something from an offensive standpoint on that last drive, Jason?
Yeah, that last drive, they utilized Mike Wright's legs a lot, creating open space with him and that offensive line getting in front of him. You'll probably see a lot of the same here, Andy, in this drive here as well, and trying to hit some of those deep over routes. We got to be alert in coverage.
Ball from the left hash mark, first down. Play action by Wright, floats it out to Xavier Thomas up the sideline. I think he lost a yard or two on the play.
Yeah, trying to throw that screen backside right there. Jalen McLeod doing a good job of staying home, not playing his assignment is basically what he did right there, Andy.
A loss of one back to the 32 for Mississippi State. 27-13, Auburn on top, State football. Second and 11 for the Bulldogs. Right from the left hash mark, brings a man in motion. Wright wants to run it. He does. He gets back to the line of scrimmage. That's about all. Auburn's pursuit, very good. Larry Nixon, the third, gets off the bottom of the pile. It's a gain of three on the play, and it's going to bring up third down and eight for Mississippi State, which is one of eight today, one of two in the second half.
Yeah, good job out of Auburn defense right there, but understanding what Mississippi State was trying to do, trying to get back to a third and manageable situation. Great job of staying home, understanding they like to run that quarterback draw with Mike Wright, creating a third and long situation right here.
Pittman is the tailback, flanks right to his left. Third and eight, Wright drops the throw, rolls to the Auburn boundary with some pressure, gets rid of it, throws it incomplete. The intended target was Tulu Griffin, but Wright was getting all kinds of pressure.
Getting a lot of pressure right there, it looked like, from Jalen McLeod and Cam Riley, yep. Both right there. getting a lot of pressure on him, making him throw that ball over Tulu.
That's a three and out for the Auburn defense. Three and out tracker driven by Truckworks, official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Second three and out by the Auburn defense today.
Yeah,
Coy Moore out to take this punt. Go ahead.
Yeah, that was a big stop, Andy, just because of the simple fact that you felt some of this momentum kind of going Mississippi State's way. Good job by the defense right there creating that ball, getting it back to the offense.
Keelan Cribbins will punt it away. High snap to him. He gets it away. End over end. Coy Moore lets it bounce. It takes a state or make then an Auburn bounce. And it is downed at the 32-yard line. 33-yard punt by Cribbins. Auburn ball. When we return, 11:31 to go in the fourth, Auburn 27, Mississippi State 13. As part of Auburn's military appreciation game, we want to thank our partner, Austal USA, an industry leader in defense shipbuilding based in Mobile. Join their team in engineering, design, construction crafts, operations, and IT. Learn more about how you can redefine maritime excellence at austaljobs.com. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
The sweet smell of victory and grilled burgers still hang in the air. Your tailgate was a big win thanks to your Ford F-150 truck. With available Pro Power onboard, you used your F-150 as a mobile generator. That kept the celebration going long after the final whistle. See your local Ford dealer for great offers on a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. See owner's manual for important operating instructions.
Hey Auburn fans, it's Coach Hugh Freeze. Care teams at Ascension St. Vincent's care for the whole person. They know healthy lifestyles help prevent chronic illnesses, and cultivating a healthy lifestyle starts early. That's why we're partnering with them to sack obesity. For every Auburn sack, a donation is made to the Ascension St. Vincent Foundation to purchase PE equipment for schools around the state. Join Jill and me by making a donation to SAC Childhood Obesity. Visit stvhsfoundation.org, War Eagle.
Andy Burcham here to tell you about our friends over at Truckworks, the official commercial truck dealer of the Auburn Tigers. Truckworks is Alabama's exclusive Kenworth, Hino, and Isuzu commercial truck dealer, and the Southeast headquarters for dump trucks, sleeper trucks, box vans, and everything in between. Step into their TRP parts store in Opelika for all your commercial truck, trailer, and bus parts needs. Truckworks, the partner you can count on in the transportation industry since 1978.
We always picture the SEC student athlete for their speed, their vertical, their agility, but it's time we picture them for more. For their campus voice, their community outreach, and for the simple fact that 20 years later, they're still someone's pride and joy. More than students, more than athletes. In the SEC, it just means more.
First and 10 for Auburn at its own 32 after a big three and out by the Auburn defense. It's second of the afternoon. Tigers lead Mississippi State 27-13. First and 10 for Auburn at its own 32. Damari Alston is the tailback. High snap. They hand the ball to Austin, and Damari goes forward. He gets maybe a yard, and that's about all.
Yeah, we had to be careful here, Andy, making sure that I know we want to run the football and continue to work that clock, but also keep your aggressiveness a little bit. Keeping these outside guys involved in the game, we've done really well of going tempo offense and putting pressure on Mississippi State's defense.
Hooks and Burton split to the Mississippi State boundary. Alston goes in motion to the Auburn boundary out of the backfield. On second down and nine for the Tigers. The snap, they bring the blitz. Thorne flushed out of the pocket. Peyton Thorne to the 30, 35, up the sideline near the 40. Nicely run by Peyton Thorne for Auburn. Run out of bounds by Nathaniel Watson. Excuse me, he was the one that came on the blitz.
Yeah, really good job right there, Peyton, eluding the rush right there. Like I said, Watson, one of those guys that has a knack for the football, coming on a blitz right there, able to get through. But Peyton Thorne outrunning him to the sideline right there, giving us a third and three situation, more of a managed down for us.
6 yard gain for Thorne. Third and three from the Auburn 39. Alston, the tailback. They shift defensively up front. They bring the house. They hand off to Mari Alston. And Alston's going to come up about a yard shy of the first down.
I like the play call right there, trying to get Damari Austin coming up. I mean, trying to get Damari Austin in between the tackles right there on fourth down. State just made a good stop right there, creating another fourth down. I think this is the right decision, and I think you need to punt the football. You're up two touchdowns. You want to give State an opportunity to have a short field right here, put points on the board.
Yeah, Auburn with fourth and one from its own 41-yard line. Reed Hughes will snap this to Oscar Chapman. Chapman rolls to his right and booms it. Thomas will let it bounce. Takes an Auburn bounce, but gets into the end zone. Well, he almost coffin-cornered that one.
Yeah, it was great hustle right there by Anthony getting down the field as fast as he did, trying to corner that ball before going to the end zone.
9:35 to go in the fourth quarter. Auburn leads it 27-13. State ball. Let's send it upstairs. Paul Ellen has this Yellowwood scoreboard update.
All right, on the Yellowwood scoreboard, Georgia just rolls on. 29-7, they lead Florida late in the third quarter in Jacksonville. Texas, number 7, beating BYU 21-6 in Austin. Big day for Bo Nix as Oregon has gone into Utah. They lead 35-6 going to the fourth quarter. And Louisville shutting out Duke 23-0 as they play in the fourth. Andy?
Paul, thank you. First and 10 for State. Right deep drop. Looks. He throws to the boundary. Pass is complete to the 35-yard line to Xavier Thomas. That was Nehemiah Pritchett in coverage, but that's a first down for State to the 36.
Yeah, Mike Wright and Thomasina found something on these deep over routes, but State is doing a good job of giving him some time to run that deep over route, and Mike Wright hit him right along that sideline right there for a first down for Mississippi State.
They gave him to the 35. First down for Mississippi State. Wright turns, hands the ball to the tailback, and that's number 23, Seth Davis, for 3 yards before Eugene Asante comes up for his ninth tackle of the game.
Yeah, Mississippi State trying to go with a little bit more tempo offense. Time running down on them in the fourth quarter here. Auburn defense, they got to make sure that they get set quickly, but also just don't give up the big play. Play bend, but don't break defense in this situation.
Asante with a career-high 12 tackles at Cal and LSU. Flag is down. Keontae Scott was on the blitz.
False start. Offense, number 75. 5-yard penalty. Remains second down.
That's Percy Lewis, backup tackle, that jumped. Keontae Scott came off that left edge. And it's first and 15 now for Mississippi State. Excuse me. Second and 12 from the 33.
Auburn be alert for Mike Wright's quarterback keeper.
Ball between the hashes. Wright drops. Now flushed out of the pocket, rolls to the Auburn boundary, and he throws it away. Pursuit that time by Eugene Asante. The intended receiver was Justin Robinson, or maybe just the sideline.
Yeah, right there. Anytime you push that quarterback close to the sideline right there, you use it as an extra defender if you're a defensive guy, making him have to get rid of the football right there. Great job of defense of staying home and not allowing Mississippi State to get a big play right
State
there.
State is 1 of 9 on third down today. This is third and 12 from the 33. And with clock at 8:27, it's a big point of the ball game, especially for the State offense. Line to get is the 45. Wright drops. Auburn rushes 4. He throws. Passes complete. Gets away. First down across midfield and out of bounds at the Auburn 45-yard line. Antonio Harmon.
Yeah, right there on defense, we got caught. Donovan Coffin playing man coverage. Mississippi State right there running a deep out route with their tight end right there with a big catch by Vic Ryland. Was able to escape and pick up a first down right there for Mississippi State.
Second third down conversion of the day for State, but into Auburn territory at the 46. Right from the gun, right hash mark. Drops to throw. Looks, he throws. It is incomplete, almost intercepted. Pass was intended for Tulu Griffin, almost picked off by Nehemiah Pritchett.
Yeah, great throw right there as well, though. Putting that ball where Tulu can get it, but Pritchett, like you said, was coming in on that right there. And also Keontae Scott right there again in coverage, almost being able to create a turnover.
Right on the afternoon, 11 of 22, 127 yards and a touchdown. He was 8 of 12 for 85 yards last week in that 7-3 win at Arkansas. Second and 10 from the 46, 7:50 to go in the fourth quarter. Wright drops to throw again. little bit of pressure, heaves it deep, and it's picked off Zion Puckett at the five.
Great job by Zion Puckett right there, reading the eyes of the quarterback. Mike Wright thinking he got one-on-one coverage, gonna try to take a shot on the post route. Zion Puckett playing deep defender back there. Great job of keeping his eyes alert. I don't think Wright saw him. Great interception right there for the Auburn defense. Another turnover for this team that leads in the SEC in turnovers.
10th interception of the year for the Tigers. That means another $1,000 for Children's of Alabama through the Picks for Kids program. Chick-fil-A donating $1,000 for each Tiger pick. That's 10 interceptions, $10,000 for Children's of Alabama. Eat more chicken and War Eagle from Chick-fil-A. 7:43 to go in the fourth. Auburn 27, Mississippi State 13. Tiger ball at its own five when we return, as Auburn football continues in a moment.
In football, it's important to call the right play. In life, it can be even more important to make the right call, especially regarding termite protection. To protect my home, I called Cook's Pest Control and got the Centricon system. You don't have to live with termites. For a free quote, make the right call. Cook's Pest Control and the Centricon system.
Looky, 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 here comes Cookie, Cook's Pest Control.
Yellowwood knows that a five-star backyard is the place to make lasting memories, like roasting marshmallows on a cool fall night. That's it. Turn it nice and slow. Get it toasted all. Oh, no, it's on fire. Oh, you want it on fire. Okay, that's a choice, I guess. Crunchy. For five-star backyards and the most memorable experiences, Yellowwood brand pressure-treated pine. If it doesn't have that yellow tag, you don't want it.
Who out there likes to eat chicken? Did you know that when it comes to chicken production, Alabama rules the roost? In fact, we're ranked second in the country in broiler production. That's meat-type chickens, with nearly 2,600 poultry farm families raising more than 1 billion birds a year. Alabama's poultry industry adds more than $15 billion a year to the state's economy and provides jobs for almost 90,000 Alabamians. So be sure to prepare your favorite chicken dish this football season.
After the game, catch the Regions Bank postgame show. We'll have locker room interviews with players, assistants, and head coach Hugh Freeze, plus scores, highlights, and analysis, all on the Regions Bank postgame show. Show your Tiger pride and get a win for your wallet with the Auburn University Regions Visa debit card and the prepaid Regions Now card. Order now at regions.com/go Tigers.
Today's game between the Tigers and Bulldogs is presented by Alabama Extension, where extending knowledge means improving lives for everyone in Alabama. Visit aces.edu to learn more. Now, back to Jordan-Hare for more of Auburn and Mississippi State.
First and 10 for Auburn from the 5. 7:43 to go in the fourth. Auburn 27, Mississippi State 13, after the second career interception for Zion Puckett and his second in as many games.
Yeah, our safeties have been active this year in getting interceptions between Puckett and Simpson.
Thorne from the pistol with Jarquez behind him. Jarquez right up the middle gets a yard before he is stood up by the interior of that Mississippi State defensive front. Clock rolling down, under 7.5 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, we haven't been able to run the ball as efficient as we did in that first half. Right now, in the second half against Mississippi State, they made a few adjustments a little bit.
Malcolm Johnson Jr. to the wide side of the field, the state boundary. Coy Moore in the slot. Peyton Thorne in the end zone gets pressured and throws it forward to about the 5-yard line, back to about the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, smart job by Peyton to get rid of that ball beyond that line of scrimmage, Andy, because it had almost been intentional grounding. The fact that he was in the end zone would have ended up in a safety.
Yeah, but it wasn't.
Correct.
Moore back into the Auburn set. Sets up in the slot to the right. Rivaldo Fairweather split wide left on third down. Thorne in the end zone, throws it up the field. The pass is complete for a first down to Brandon Frazier. Frazier just kind of snuck off the line of scrimmage, had to go down to his ankles to make the catch.
We got a flag here, and it might be an ineligible man downfield.
An eligible player downfield. Offense, number 52. The penalty will be enforced half the distance of the goal. Third down.
Oh, dear.
As we look again, that's another hairy call right there. You know, Auburn running a little play action, sneaking Brandon Frazier. I love the play design. They're trying to call Dylan Wade being beyond that 2 yards downfield. But if you watch the replay, he was kind of hanging right there. He wasn't really trying to go past that 2 yards. Sometimes they let those go.
A hairy call?
Yeah, that was a little hairy right there.
Okay. Third and to 12 for Auburn. Clock rolling with 6:44 and counting. From the Auburn 3 yard line, Thorne sends Jarquez, and it's Thorne on a quarterback draw, and he gets out to the 3.5 yard line, and that is all. And a timeout called by State stops the clock with 6 minutes and 29 seconds to go in the fourth. It's still a 2-touchdown game. And Auburn leads it by a score of 27-13. Auburn to punt it away when we come back, leading 27-13. 6:29 to go in the fourth. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Tackle your to-do list this season and find the right Aetna Medicare plan for you in your home state of Alabama. With Aetna Medicare Advantage plans, you can get a $0 monthly plan premium with hospital, medical, and prescription drug coverage. Plans also include dental, vision, and an over-the-counter benefit. Be the star quarterback of your health. Call us for a personalized coverage review now. 1-833-771-7542. TTY-711. Aetna Medicare is an HMO PPO plan with a Medicare contract. RSNPs also have contracts with state Medicaid programs. Enrollment in our plans depends on contract renewal. Plan features and availability may vary by service area.
We've all been caught up in the little chores that pile up every day. The dishes in the sink, the trash that needs taking out, the pesky check engine light. Isn't it time to make a change and escape to a whole new world of possibilities? Where there's dinner without dishes, nights filled with adventure, and every day you feel like a winner. A little change can go a long way when you escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical.
You always say Vibrantly Tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
When you live in SEC country, you feel it everywhere you go. The traditions and rivalries surround you. As much as you celebrate the game, Regions celebrates your financial wins even more. And like SEC fans, we'll never quit. Because in an SEC world, we're the SEC Bank. Regions, official bank of the SEC. Member FDIC.
.6:32 to go in the fourth. Auburn 27, Mississippi State 13. Ronnie Brown, what have you seen from the Auburn offense here in the second half with this Cook's Pest Control sideline report?
Well, I think it's been more of a serene mindset. You know, they've come out, they haven't had the same type of energy, hasn't been the same type of tempo, and I think as a result of that, haven't been able to put a lot of points, get a lot going offensively. And so they're going to have to do a good job if they want to try to get another score up, try to just go ahead and put this game to rest. But they got to pick up the energy and the morale a little bit down here. Right. Defensively, it's been the same thing, but they've been able to be more effective.
All right, this is a big snap for Reed Hughes because Oscar Chapman is about a foot inside the back line. It is a good snap, and Oscar gets it away in a hurry. And Thomas fields it at midfield and calls a fair catch. So a short field for State after a 47-yard punt by Chapman. Boy, he had to get rid of that in a hurry. State came after him a bit.
He got rid of it in a hurry, but he also gave it a good kick with a high arch on it to give Jeremiah Cobb time to run down there and not give Mississippi State an opportunity to get any return off of that punt.
Clock stopped with 6:26 to go in the fourth. State ball at midfield. Auburn 27, Mississippi State 13. This was not over by a long shot, friends.
Yeah, it seemed like State just keep giving these little opportunities right here around midfield. Our defense got to make another stand here.
Tulu Griffin goes in motion toward the State boundary. Play action right, flips it out. Tulu Griffin taken down back at the 46 by Keontae Scott.
Deontay Scott right there, staying with his key right there, understanding that Tulu is a guy that can get out in open space and create something fast for this Mississippi State offense. Great job of staying with your defender, Keontae Scott, right there, creating a negative play for Mississippi State.
Second and 11 at the State 49. Auburn rushes four. Great drops. A delayed blitz by Keontae Scott. Passes complete to the 40 or the 36-yard line to Tulu Griffin. Really fine throw by Mike Wright to the Auburn boundary.
Yeah, I'll be honest with you, Andy. He's made some really good throws along that boundary today on those deep overs, those seven routes right there. That was pretty much great coverage. He just put that ball right over our defender just where his guy can catch it.
And he had it. Eugene Asante bearing down on him. First down from the Auburn 36, Wright to throw again. Looks to the boundary, throws, it's incomplete. Pass intended for Thomas, defended by DJ James. Second and 10, 5:29 to go in the fourth. Auburn 27, State 13. State second and 10 from the Auburn 36.
Yeah, this is pretty good. Still a receiving core for Mississippi State that's pretty good and active. Even after losing Ra-Ra Thomas, the transfer that went to Georgia, they still got some guys that can go and catch the football.
Trips to the wide side of the field. That's the State boundary. A single receiver to the short side, the Auburn boundary. And now Pittman in motion out of the backfield sets up as the wide receiver left. Right, quarterback draw. Right gets to the line of scrimmage and gets a yard, and that is all. And it is Austin Keys to make the stop for Auburn.
Yeah, Austin Keys right there doing a good job of making sure Auburn came on a little bit of a rush, but understand he's already in the spy technique on Mike Wright anyways. If they was to pass the ball, he ended up running a quarterback draw, so that just led him right to the hands of Austin Keys right there. Big stop, big third down right here coming up for this Auburn defense.
State on the day, 2 of 10 on third down. This is third and 9 from the Auburn 35. Right from the gun, Pittman to his right. Wright drops to throw, throws to the boundary, passes complete, but shy of the first down for Creed Whitmore. He's about a yard and a half shy of the first down. It's fourth down and a yard and a half for State. They've got to go for it.
Yeah, they're going to mark him by fourth and two here, Andy. They're going to say his foot went out of bounds before gaining that extra yard. We know this is two down territory right here, so the fourth down right here for Auburn, for Auburn's defense to get off the field.
State needs 2 yards. They're 1 of 2 on fourth down today.
Auburn needs to be alert for Mike Wright as well as the running back here.
Pittman in the pistol behind Wright. The snap, the handoff, Pittman surges forward, and he has, I think, just enough for the first down. It will depend on the spot.
Yeah, they may have to measure this.
Nope, they're going to give him a first down.
But right here, the clock is against Mississippi State right here. Auburn's defense is okay with them running the ball and continue to take time off that clock right now.
Robinson and Thomas to the Auburn boundary. Tulu Griffin now comes in motion, sets up in the slot. Wright drops the throw, gets pressured, throws it. It's caught by Thomas at the 20. Thomas goes out of bounds at the Auburn 15.
Got two Auburn guys hurt in the backfield right there. Look like Austin Keys and Marcus Harris.
Austin Keys runs off the field under his own power, takes off his helmet in the process.
Oh, they ran right into each other. You'll see right here, Mike Wright stepped up to throw that ball right there to Xavion Thomas, and end up Austin Keys and Marcus Harris both collided.
That's the 9th catch of the day for Thomas for 112 yards. It's the best game of his Mississippi State career. He had a career-high 5 catches for 56 yards at South Carolina, but boy, today, 9 catches, 112 yards in his first career touchdown.
Yeah, he's had a big day today against our man defense that Auburn has been running today, giving those guys, you know, opportunities to win their one-on-one matchups. But
Marcus Harris gets up, and he will walk off the field under his own power, being escorted by the Auburn medical staff.
Yeah, that's good to see Marcus Harris, one of our experienced players on that defensive front right there. Just effort, though, Andy. You know, Austin Keys and Marcus Harris playing with a lot of effort trying to end this ball game. Unfortunately, ran into each other right there to create both of those guys to end up on the field. But glad to see both of them up and walking on their own ability.
All right. They're neither one on the field, though, for first and 15 for Mississippi State, or first and 10 from the Auburn 15. Wright drops to throw. Throws to the boundary. Passes complete through to the tailback for 5 or 4 yards in the play, Jeffrey Pittman.
Yeah, remember that clock continues to run until there's 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter, so it matters if you go out of bounds. They set the ball and the clock starts again, so.
They only gave him 2 yards on the play, 2nd and 8. From the Auburn 13, clock rolls down to the 3:14 mark. Tigers up by 14. Thomas came in motion. He moved forward before the snap. Wright throws to the end zone. It's caught by Thomas for a touch. Oh, he was out of bounds. Excuse me, didn't hang on to the football.
Yeah, like that right foot came down out of bounds right there. Another great throw, though, by Mike Wright. Gets really good coverage.
Did Thomas not start moving forward as after he was coming in motion before the snap?
Yeah, let's watch the replay here. It was close. It was very close right there. But I think he caught the ball, but I think their right or left foot touched out of bounds.
3rd and 8 for State at the Auburn 13. Clock stop with 3:05 remaining in the fourth. Trips to the wide side of the field. We may get a review of this play.
Ruling on the field is an incomplete pass. The previous play is under video review.
Yeah, that's out of bounds.
Another look. Yeah, he's out of bounds with the left foot when he comes down.
Yeah, they simultaneously hit, so you got to call that out of bounds because that was the original call on the field.
Well, you'd think so.
But you never know.
Yeah, we found that out last week.
Right.
The Auburn fans agree with you, Jason. He was out of bounds.
Yeah, he was out of bounds. Last time I checked, I had pretty good vision when I went for my testing a couple weeks ago.
I went this week. Not that anyone cares.
Yeah, they care.
His foot comes down out of bounds. We get another look at it very close, and yeah, his right foot is in, but it looks like his left foot plants first.
Yeah, I don't see how you can overturn this. Yeah. Both of them hit at the same time.
Here comes the call.
The call of an incomplete pass stands.
Thank you, Daniel Gautreau. So it is 3rd and 8 for State at the Auburn 13-yard line. 3:05 to go in the fourth quarter. Auburn 27, Mississippi State 13. State has scored the game's only touchdown in the second half. They send trips to the right. Harmon, Pittman, and Robinson. Excuse me, Harmon, Pittman, and Thomas.
Yeah, look out down bottom there. We got Nehemiah Pritchett versus their big guy, Robinson. Look for them to try to throw a back shoulder or a high ball to him on this third down right here.
Robinson, 6'4", 220. He's in the slot. The snap to right. Play action. Looks to the State boundary. Throws it across the middle. Almost intercepted by Cam Riley at the goal line. Oh, he had his hands on that one, and he knows he should have had an interception.
Yeah, Cam Riley be seeing that one in his sleep tonight when he's trying to get some good rest from this game.
Good to see Marcus Harris, by the way, back on the field for that play.
Yes, indeed. And like we talked about, Andy, Mike Wright did look to Richardson to try, Robinson to try to throw that back shoulder. Auburn did a good job of playing two uncut on that side, running a defensive end underneath in a corner playing over top, forcing him to throw that ball back to the field. Almost intercepted by Cam Riley, creating a huge fourth down that could possibly end the game right here.
4th and 8 for State at the Auburn 13. Right from the left hash mark. There's the snap in the gun. He looks to the end zone. The pass is complete for a touchdown. Or was he out? No, he was out of bounds. The pass intended for Justin Robinson, backing up on the play. And that should turn it over to Auburn.
And that should be your ball game unless something crazy happens. But I think if Auburn just run the football, hold on to the ball, don't try to get anything, don't try to do anything fancy. If you're a running back right now, two hands on the ball, make sure you protect it at all costs.
Robinson, the 6'4", 220-pound redshirt junior, was working on Nehemiah Pritchett. He actually had a step on Pritchett in the end zone, but was out of bounds along the sideline.
Yeah, it was definitely close right here as we watch it on the TV copy. Yep, that left foot touching just out of bounds right there.
Boy, State dangerously close on two passes to the end zone, but came up empty. Auburn 1st and 10 at its own 13, 2:55 to go in the fourth. State has 2 timeouts to stop the clock. Handoff. Tailback bouncing outside Jarquez Hunter. Jarquez 20, 25, stays in bounds to the 30. 17 yards for Jarquez Hunter.
Good job of Jarquez right there, being patient on that, letting his line get out in front of him, getting a chance to get around the edge right there. And the most important thing he did was stay in bounds.
Clock continues to roll down, 2:28 to go in the fourth quarter. On the night, or the day, Jarquez over 90 yards for his second straight game, 94 yards on 16 carries.
Yeah, he would love to get another 7 or 8 right there to give him another 100-yard game back-to-back against his two schools that he's from, Mississippi, Philadelphia.
Jarquez has 5 100-yard games in his Auburn career. Jarquez right up the middle. Jarquez header into the clear, 40, 45, 50. 45 for Mississippi State, 40 down the sideline, 30, and out of bounds at the 20, and that'll put him over 100 yards.
Yeah, Jarquez right there, a little tired on the sideline. That definitely puts him over 100 yards right there.
50 yards on the gallop by Jarquez Hunter.
They might have to bring the oxygen tank out to Jarquez and meet him at the 30-yard line, because I don't know if he's going to make it to the sideline.
He's going to come out. Damari Alston comes in. 144 yards on the day for Jarquez Hunter.
Yeah, we might not see Jarquez for the rest of this game. I think he just sealed the deal right there. I think Auburn's going to be content with maybe just running his clock out right here. I don't think Mississippi State would use their timeouts.
It's 3 yards under his career high of 147 yards against State. Peyton Thorne carries and gets bulldozed back at the 26-yard line. Clock stopped with a minute 21 to go on a timeout by State. Corey Ellington, junior out of Lexington, Mississippi, made the stop. He had a strip sack last week in that win at Arkansas. It'll be second and 16 for Auburn at the 26-yard line. So Jarquez Hunter, 17 carries, 144 yards, 3 yards behind his career high of 147 against Alabama State. That's the game where he had that 90-some yard touchdown run, yeah, setting the Auburn school record.
Yep. Back-to-back weeks, Jarquez had over 100 yards rushing.
And that's good news.
Yeah, that's really
good. Oh, that's good news for the Auburn run game.
You know, he missed the first game of the season, and then just trying to use some of those other games to get it back, get his legs back into shape. But you can tell now he's running at a different speed than he did 3 to 4 weeks ago.
Second and 16 for Auburn from the 26. He's back in the ball game in the pistol. Fairweather in motion, sets up as the tight end. Bad snap. Thorne will fall on it back at the 35.
That's something you don't want to see right there. Is you want to close the game out the right way. You don't want that ball to be.
And State calls his final timeout, stopping the clock with a minute 18 to go. The snap was, was that deflected somehow at the line? It was to the right of Thorne, and he just fell on it.
Yeah, I love to see the back angle camera on this right here, because the ball seemed like it was going to the right and not directly backwards. Yeah, it seemed like it hit the left arm of Cam Stutz on the snap.
All right. Next up for the Tigers, Auburn plays at Vanderbilt next Saturday afternoon at 3. We'll have coverage on the Auburn Sports Network starting at noon Central Time. And don't forget, Auburn women's basketball in action, exhibition against West Georgia Monday night at 7, Auburn men's basketball hosting AUM Wednesday night at 7. Coverage on the Auburn Sports Network app. Thorne throws it to the end zone, and incomplete, and a flag. It's going to be interference. Pass intended for Amari Kelly, and he was nearly bulldozed over.
Yeah, you're exactly right right there. Auburn saying Mississippi State utilized their timeouts.
Defense, number 3. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
DeCameron Richardson is number 3 for State. Minute 12 to go in the fourth. Auburn 27, State 13. Peyton Thorne, his best game as an Auburn Tiger through the air, 20 of 27, 230 yards and 3 touchdowns. Jarquez Hunter, 17 carries for 144 yards.
Yeah, Auburn should just take a knee here.
Can't stop the clock. State cannot. Thorne takes the first knee. Auburn will probably need to snap it one or two more times. And Auburn will pick up its first SEC victory of the season and snap a 4-game losing streak as it heads to Vanderbilt on Saturday in Nashville, a 3:00 kickoff, our coverage at noon. Thorne will need to take one more snap. As he gets to the line of scrimmage, play clock is down to 13.
Yeah, I just need to wait, let it get underneath that.
Here's the snap, there's the knee, and that's going to do it, friends. Auburn scored on its first two drives of the day. The Tigers beat Mississippi State, snapping State's win streak against Auburn at 2. The two head coaches, Hugh Freeze and Zach Garnett, meet at midfield, and Auburn has won its first SEC game of the season. As the clock rolls down, Auburn will get to celebrate tonight. The Tigers win it by a score of 27-13. Jarquez Hunter, 17 carries, 144 yards. Peyton Thorne, 20 of 26 for 230 yards and 3 touchdowns on the day. And Auburn spread out the offense as well, and the Tigers win it 27-13. Auburn's defense did a job as well. Eugene Asante with 9 tackles, 7 for Keontae Scott. The Tigers are winners, 27-13 at Jordan-Hare Stadium. Stay tuned, Auburn football continues in a moment.
This is Coach Hugh Freeze. The support of the Auburn family is vital to the success of our student athletes, and On to Victory plays a crucial role in that. Please help keep that good work going by joining On to Victory today, War Eagle.